else, or you'll catch your chilling. Stay away from that window.
More decent than some of my frocks back home. Should have seen me. A scandal hour.
I'd rather not hear about it. Now, where are you going today?
Some art gallery. This would be nice for an art gallery. Oh, you'd look pretty in that, but put it on.
Oh, it wouldn't fit. I'm too plump.
Oh, wear this. She'll like me in this.
No, I think that's more for a big occasion. This is the one. Here we are now.
She's bossy, isn't she, Mrs. Trotter? The folks at home are blunt, but they got nought on her.
Oh, she's famous for her bluntness.
You'll have to get used to it like the rest of us. She doesn't always mean it. Careful, you'll tear it.
Sorry.
Would you call her a lady?
Well, she's a lady in one sense. She's made herself into a lady, the way she dresses and things like that. But she's never forgotten where she's come from, which is a poor part of London, and she's not ashamed of it. That's why she speaks the way she does. It's like me being Welsh and you Yorkshire. You can nose the lilt if you try, but some people prefer not to.
You don't know much about her. She was a cook, weren't she?
Oh, the most famous cook in all London. She cooked for the King of England and he gave her a sovereign once.
That where she met Lord Aylesmere, cooking in smart houses.
Lord Aylesmere? Can't remember, probably. Come on now, the poor Major will be wondering where you've got to.
That's the one for the Derby, Major.
Grand Parade, 33 to 1. Bit forlorn, isn't it?
Oh, look at the sire.
All no, big. No, look, man, Dominion's a choice from that stable. Smith up, 109. The other one's just making out the numbers.
I can't say more, Major.
Well, I still have a hankering for the Panther. A pound to
a
win.
Panther? You'll eat your money.
Oh, you're looking.
Excuse me.
Oh, well, we'll take a cab. Come on.
Brandy, sir.
No, thank you, ma'am.
Oh, thank you, sir.
Yeah. We're old survivors, you and I. Seen a great many things in our time, wouldn't you agree?
Oh, seen it all, sir.
Oh, precisely. Not easily fooled by the secrets of the human heart. I mean, what we don't know, what we are not told, we guess. And our experience usually proves us correct. Ah, take, for example, our friend the Major, and that heavenly young vision from the Yorkshire Dales on his arm. New clothes each day she wears. Is the Major in funds? Unlikely. Is he in love?
I really hadn't noticed, sir.
You hadn't? I'm surprised that you know.
Oh, see a good number of things I don't necessarily notice, sir.
Comment on your failing powers.
Well, comment on the nature of my business, sir. It's my opinion nobody leads an entirely blameless life. We all have our little secrets, which are best left secret, aren't they?
Yes, but not in the case of the gallant Major. He flaunts his treasure.
Which suggests to me he has nothing to hide. Excuse me, sir.
That remains to be seen.
Right, Ethel. Summon for number 6. Put it out of the way, will you? Fetch me that lamp from over there. Have you finished that pudding yet for number 3?
I'll give it a chance.
She's blocking.
What?
I think it's that girl that come back from Yorkshire, Mrs. Trotter.
Well, she's no right to be down here. Get rid of her.
Excuse me, miss. You're not allowed down here. I've seen nothing like it. Are you the cook?
Well, miss, I'm not the postman, am I?
Lovely food. Best I've ever had in my life since I come here.
Oh, thank you very much, miss.
Went for Mrs. Trotter, did you?
No, miss. Certainly not. I'd be very much obliged, miss, if you didn't touch the food.
I just wanted to watch. She's talking, doesn't that being watched when she's cooking this?
I just wanted to ask a favour.
And what might that be?
I wanted to ask if I could cook Mrs. Trotter's dinner tonight.
What, miss? You come down here and cook dinner for Mrs. Trotter?
Aye, that's right. As a surprise, like.
You mean, come into my kitchen?
Mrs. Trotter's kitchen by rights, isn't it?
Ethel, finish that pudding.
Where's she after? You're in soup now, miss.
Madam, I've got a very busy evening. I've got 4 dinner parties, including the mayor of New York, and there's a girl in my kitchen making a thorough nuisance of herself. Would you kindly tell her to leave me alone, or I won't answer for the consequences?
What are you doing in the kitchen?
Nothing.
Well, you can't go down there.
She wanted to cook your supper, it seems.
What?
Well, meant to be a surprise, but she's gone and spoiled it all by making a fuss.
I made a fuss.
Yeah, all right. All right, Mrs. Cochrane. I'll handle this.
She's going to put my timetable all out. She has all this I've ever been short.
All right, Mrs. Cochrane.
Thank you, madam.
What's the matter with her?
What's the matter? You've upset her. That's what the matter is. That's all I need. This is a hotel. You can't go running around the place interfering with people upsetting everybody.
Just wanted to cook your supper, that's all.
Did you? What do you know about cooking?
I cooked it all for my mum, for Elsie.
Your soggy boiled cabbage and burnt sausages, I've no doubt.
No, it weren't that bad. You can ask her.
Now, you listen, my girl. If you want to be a cook, you start from the bottom like I did, scrubbing the vegetables. Do you know how long it took me before I was even allowed to touch a piece of meat? 4 years. Is that what you want for yourself now? Is it?
I didn't say I wanted to be a cook. I just wanted to do something. I can't go trailing around with Major every day, staring at blooming paintings and eating fat teas all over blooming place.
What's your language?
But I just wanted to do something for you.
Yeah, well, I appreciate what you was trying to do, Lottie, but you went the wrong way about it. You're Lord Hazelmere's daughter. The kitchen is no place for you. Want to do something? Well, that's very commendable. I'll have to think of something. I don't know what. Not suited for much, are you?
It ain't my fault, is it?
No, I never said it was. It's difficult, I'm aware of that.
Never seen him in his uniform before.
Aye.
My father. Looks very handsome, doesn't he? Oh, the village thought he was handsome. They were proud of him.
Yeah, so they should be. He won the DSO.
I know. Could I have a picture of him? Keep it hidden under my pillow.
You'd squash it.
Well, in a drawer with them, with things. Oh, nobody'd see it, I promise.
Yeah, I'll look one out for you.
And one of you.
He came back for his violin. Walked in the door after 7 months. He looked terrible, poor man. He'd been unemployed, you see, like so many of them. He was too proud to come and see me without any prospects. He was a lieutenant, up from the ranks. Quite a hero, I think, though he doesn't like talking about it. Anyway, finally he got a job, playing in an orchestra in a Tay Dansant. He's a marvellous violinist. I slip out when I can and listen to him. Sometimes I get asked to dance, and I think he feels quite jealous. I always refuse, of course. You must come and meet him, and tell me if I'm off Morocco, will you?
That's a dance hall.
No, not there. It's not a very nice place, actually. We'll have tea together, the three of us, on his afternoon off. We can make a nice outing. Good night.
Night.
Shall I leave a light on?
Yeah.
Do what? We do things every day.
Well, I found her an occupation. That's what I meant. Does she show any interest in anything?
We've been to the Tate twice. She quite likes the Turners. But there's plenty of time, isn't there? Actually, I was going to ask you if I could be excused for a bit. I find all this running about rather exhausting.
You don't look too bad on it.
But rumours will start, if not already. My reputation to consider.
Improve it, I should think. What's she talk about?
Oh, everything. Everything. She's a fountain of curiosity.
About Charlie?
Sometimes. Questions slipped in. She's rather cunning about that. Building the jigsaw in her own time. Can't blame her, can you?
Myths and legends. The confuser.
I'd do my best to tell her the truth. I think she's handling it all rather well. She'd like to see more of you, of course.
I'm sorry, madam, but I've got your winnings for the Derby, madam.
Oh.
Grand Parade at 33 to 1. You right. Never backed it.
Why shouldn't I have? Thank you, Sal.
Major was on the favourite, the Panther. I tried to warn him. Didn't do too well, did he, Major, the Panther? He threw his head up on the way to the post, then he broke the tapes before they started. Then he threw his head up again at the off and lost a dozen lengths, thought his jockey got him going, and halfway round.
Must you rub it in?
Oh, by the way, I've been given two tickets for the final of the ladies' challenge round at Wimbledon on the 19th. It's a gentleman number three, one of the competitors. I was wondering if you'd like to have the man.
Oh,
Take Lottie.
No, thank you, Star. Don't much care for tennis. You have
them. Oh, well, thank you very much, madam.
Here, don't scoff them all. Ed Bryan, have one. He needs fattening up.
No, thank you.
Go on.
I said no. You have it.
Thanks. You smoke too many of those things. And it's rude to smoke in front of ladies.
Oh, I don't mind.
No, go on, I don't mind either. How's your room? Did you get your window fixed? Mm. Poor Brian. He lives in a small attic room on top of this drafty house with a broken window pane which the landlord simply refused to mend, didn't he? Remember that thunderstorm the other evening? Came right in on top of his head.
Maybe she'd come and live at Bentinck.
Oh, I wish she could. How much are you paying at the moment?
How long are you staying at the Bentinck?
I don't know. Up to Mrs. Trotter, I suppose. Mrs. Trotter invited her.
Don't you miss your family?
I've got none, really. My dad's passed on and my mum, well, she don't miss me. Glad to be shut of me, I shouldn't wonder.
Your dad killed in the war, was he?
No, died of flu, didn't he? Excuse me, sticky fingers. Over there.
Oh, who is she?
Oh, just a guest.
Out with the housemaid?
Housekeeper, if you don't mind. She was lonely. She didn't have any friends down here, so I thought it'd be nice if she met my friend. Beginning to wonder now, though, the way you've been looking at her.
She's pretty.
I know she is, but I am too, aren't I? At least that's what he told me.
Her dress must have cost a packet. Yorkshire accent. The daughter of a war profiteer from Bradford.
Don't ask me. I don't know who she is any more than you do. That's better.
What?
Eating instead of smoking. Oh, I brought you something from the kitchen. Half a cake and some nice pâté, especially for the French Duke, which you didn't finish. Don't let the waitress see.
I don't need you to bring me food. I'm quite all right.
No, you're not. Now, don't make a scene. Take it quickly and put it under your mat.
My mat's hanging up.
When you go out, I mean. Oh, look, I'll keep it till we get outside. It's false pride not to take things when they're offered you. You know that.
Waitress,
yes,
can I have the bill, please?
I'm paying for this.
No, you're not.
You can't afford it. It's my treat. I asked you here.
All right?
Yeah, thanks. Where are we going? Your bill, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, waitress. Heavens, this is rather a lot.
That's a pot of tea for three and nine cakes.
I'm to blame. Yes, thank you. Keep the change.
Thank you, madam.
You must get Mary to bring you to the Tate Dansant some afternoon.
No, it's not a very nice place for Miss Richards. Can't dance any road.
Well, I'll see you again, I hope, before you leave.
I expect so. Won't you walk us to our bus?
Of course.
He's my father. I know. We ain't sure if you did. Not sure who knows what. Just Mr. Starr and Mr. Merriman. And the Major, of course. We won't give it away. I don't think I'll mind if you did. It's not something to be ashamed on, is it? No. But there's other people to consider. Remember that. Oh. Well, Mrs. Trotter, for one. Have you thought of her feelings? Well, it's time you did. It's not easy for her, you know. She's given you all this. She's been more than generous, and you seem to take it all for granted.
I don't.
Well, you don't seem very grateful.
She don't want me.
No, that's just silly.
She don't know what to do with me. He'd have known. He'd have taken me places. He wouldn't have just left me.
What do you mean? Mrs. Trotter's a busy woman. She hasn't got time to...
He lived here, didn't he? Which room did he have?
Doesn't matter.
It does, I want to see it.
You can't, it's occupied.
Which number? If you don't tell me, I'll ask somebody else.
It was number 3, if you must know. Are you satisfied now?
He died here, didn't he? We must have died somewhere, and it was this hotel, wasn't it? Did he die in her arms? That's what I said in village. Is it true? Tell me.
I think she was with him, yes.
What did he die from? We weren't killed on battlefield, but he's on War Memorial. He's an hero. So what were it?
Why don't you ask Mrs. Trotter? I'm sure she'd tell you.
She won't. She tells me not. You're the only one who can tell me. You're my friend.
He was a brave man. Well, he died of his wounds that he got out in France. And perhaps that was for the best.
Why? What do you mean?
He was going blind.
Blind? My father?
There, you see, it's best not to know too much. You only upset yourself.
Tisha.
Thank you, Mamma. Thank you.
Can I help you, sir?
I'd like to see Miss Richards, please.
Miss Richards?
Yes.
Out, I'm afraid.
Oh, do you know if she'll be long?
Oh, couldn't say, sir. I got for a walk with the dog, all Forger's dog, and Major Smith Barton.
It's raining.
Well, if you care to call back, sir.
No, I think I will, thanks.
Could I have your back at her, sir? You'll make the chair wet.
Sorry.
Can I get you something, sir?
Could I have a cup of tea, please?
Afternoon tea, cake, sandwiches?
Just a cup of tea, thank you.
Cup of tea, very good, sir. Mary's young man in the aura. What's a cup of tea?
Mary's gone to Wimbledon with Mr. Starr.
I know she has.
Lovely weather for it. What's he want?
Tea.
No, what's he come to see her for? Come to propose, has he?
It's a fine time for it when she's up skylarking with another man.
Only Mr. Starr. He don't go.
As a matter of fact, he hasn't come to see Mary at all.
Who hasn't?
Mary's young man. He's come to see Miss Richards.
He took out a chill.
A tough little breed, aren't they? Hello, I know you, don't I?
Spedding, sir. You brought me here from hospital last August.
That's right. How are you? Excuse me, a damp footwear.
Hello, Brian. Do you want Mary? She's out.
Yes, I know. It's you I've come to see. Can we talk somewhere?
Oh, here.
No, not here. Somewhere private.
What's that?
Well, it's about Mary, in a way. Can we go to your room?
We will.
Anyway, please, it won't take long.
Oh, if it's really important.
It is, believe me.
All right, look, go through that door and up back stairs. Number 16 on the second floor. Don't get caught.
Oh, Saffron, get a pen on you. Everyone's gone bust.
Oh, yes, allow me. Oh. Dear lady.
Ciao, lovely. Thank you. Wait a minute.
Oh, I've got all the time in the world.
People keep thinking the blooming towels. Got to order a whole new set. I don't know. Never happened in the old days.
No, people have lost all sense of morality nowadays. One finds it in all areas of life, for general lowering of standards everywhere.
You may be right, sir.
Well, even the ancient art of gossip has sunk to miserable depths.
Well, you should know that, if anyone does.
The time was when a small indiscretion could be savoured like a delicate prawn. Now it's gobbled and spat out like a labourer's breakfast. No taste anymore.
Oh, yeah.
Take, for example, your little Yorkshire waif, whom you so generously tucked under your wing. Astonishing rumours circulating about her, as you've probably heard.
No, I never listen to gossip.
According to one informed source, she's the love child of two notable personages, not unconnected with this hotel.
What?
Of course, one does one's best to stifle such rumours, of course, but in the face of increasing evidence.
What evidence?
Bishopsley. Daughter of a groom, was it, on the master's estate?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Wardrobe, supplied by someone. And the major's curious role as watchdog, and the similarity of look.
All right, you old ratbag, spit it out.
Spit what out?
Your poison. Get over it, get out of my sight.
If I stumbled on something by accident...
Stop your mischief and get off out of here.
No, if anyone could. Stop the mischief, but it's so far advanced.
Now listen, miss, you and I'll get one thing straight, Saffron. If I find you've been telling tales to your dirty duchesses, I'll tell them what you get up to with your other boys. And that'll be your meal ticket gone, I'm warning you. Now, come on, out of here.
Oh,
come on,
my dear Louisa, calm yourself.
Yes.
We're old friends. Yes. Look, I'm quite harmless.
You're harmless as a blooming rattlesnake. Now get out, keep your bloody mouth shut. Good afternoon.
That's better.
You can't smoke here. What do they think?
Sorry.
Sit over there if you don't mind. You won't stay long, will you? I don't know what my man say, if she knew. Or Mary come to that. Well, what do you want to say?
I'm going away.
We are too?
Anyway, it doesn't matter.
But leaving London? What about your orchestra?
I packed it in. It was rotten anyway.
Well, you could find another.
No. Oh, yes, sometime maybe. It's not the point.
What will Mary say?
She's the reason I'm going.
She loves you?
I know.
Don't you love her?
She won't leave me alone. She's always organising, patting me like a stray dog. I'm not a bloody stray dog. She smothers the life out of me.
You're upset.
I'm not upset. Don't you start. I just want to be left on my own. She's a nice girl, Mary. She means well. She'll make somebody a wonderful wife, but it won't be me. I don't want to settle down. I'm playing the bloody boy, if you like. I've had enough of responsibilities and I'm getting out.
Well, you're gonna have to tell her, aren't you?
I'm asking you to tell her.
Oh, no,
you're her friend, aren't you? It has to be you. If I try, she won't let go of me. She'll probably get me a job here as a boot boy. I'm sorry, but I can't face telling her.
You'll break her out.
No, I won't. There are plenty of war heroes just begging. I'm sorry. Look, even if I did make something in my life, I wouldn't want to share it with her. I'd want to share it with someone like you.
Don't be daft.
You're my ideal.
I think you better go.
Don't worry, I'm not going to make advances. You're far out of my reach. You're a lady, for one thing, in spite of your accent.
Why'd you say that?
I know these things. I'm psychic.
I should tell you then.
Tell me what?
Nothing. Don't matter.
Goodbye, Lottie.
But you can't just go.
Saving your reputation.
What'll I tell Mary?
You'll think of something.
Suzanne Lengland versus Mrs. Lambert Chambers. Match of the blooming century.
Didn't you see nothing?
We saw the King and Queen. They were soaked to fever.
Oh, Mr. Starr, would you mind not making puddles on my kitchen floor?
Where else can we dry off with the painters still in the dispense?
Go and fetch a mop, will you?
I marched straight to the referee's room, waved the tickets in his face, called him a damn profiteer and asked for me money back.
He did too, I was with him.
Mr. Starr, you never even paid for the tickets in the first place.
It's not the point, Mrs. Cochrane, it's the principle.
Tell him what answer you got.
Never mind that.
The referee looked him straight in the eye and said, cheerio. Just that, cheerio, he said.
Can't you go and see him tomorrow?
We haven't got tickets for tomorrow.
Oh. Yes, what is it? I want to word with you, it's urgent. It's not here, upstairs.
And take your blessed shoe with you.
Oh. Grass looked lovely and green, didn't it? After all that rain.
You'll never land them by the morning. That old snake Saffron-Wooden's not going to keep his mouth shut for 5 minutes. Hell hath no fury like an old woman scorned.
It's outrageous. We've known him for years. Never liked him, mind you. Slippery, like a number of your friends.
He pays his bills. Most of them. Anyway, that's the least of our worries.
What?
Well, it's not working out, is it? Heaven or here. You can't keep taking the places, said so yourself. And Mary. Never see her these days. I've done me duty by Charlie. She can't stay here forever, that's certain.
Just till she finds her feet.
Yeah, but what's she going to do? Tell me, what's she going to be? She's going to be a working girl, like a mother or a blooming peer's daughter.
She'd be herself. We can't mould her into anything. Only guide her.
Yeah, but which way?
The way she decides. We leave it to her. She's got a mind of her own. She has interests. You know, she likes music. Sings. Chanting voice. She sang to me today in St. James's Park, before the rain came.
Yeah, well, it's not what she decides, it's what I decide. Have a look at these.
Finishing schools. Switzerland.
Yeah, she can learn to sing if she wants to. And she can learn the King's English at the same time.
Here's your supper.
It's lovely tonight. Chicken done Mrs. Cochrane's special way. You heard what happened to us in Wimbledon, I suppose? Oh, so funny. What have you been doing all day? Not stuck indoors, I hope.
Took Fred for a while.
Oh, did you go willingly? Always a bit fussy when I take her.
Rained. Fred got soaked.
Oh, dear. That won't please Mr. Starr either. Should you give her a rub down? Hope it's fine tomorrow. There's a victory parade in the morning. We won't see it, shall we? Brian will want to see it. He may even be marching. Come on, eat up, it'll get cold.
Look very hungry.
Not ill, are you? Let me feel your pocket.
No, I'm all right.
Something happened? Something to Mrs. Trotter? What is it? You can tell me.
Brian.
What about Brian?
He came in this afternoon.
To the hotel? Well, silly of him. I told him I'd be out. What did he want?
He asked me to...
What?
To tell you he's going away.
leaving his job, leaving London.
Oh, that's impossible. He can't do that. Why should he? Did he say why?
Just had to be on his own. Get away for a bit. That's what he said.
Oh, why should he tell you that? Why couldn't he tell me himself?
Thought you might try and stop him.
Oh, of course I would. Of course I'd try. He doesn't know what he's doing. Leave him? Did he come up here and tell you? This room? Has he been up here?
Yeah.
He didn't do anything to you, did he?
Oh, no, he's a perfect gentleman.
What did he say about me?
Nothing. I mean, you're such a good person. I tried to tell him. You're much better than me. They won't listen. It's not what you think, honestly. He's muddled about war and that. Oh, Mary, please don't cry. Don't cry. You'll find somebody else, I know you will.
No, I won't.
Well, how long was he up there?
About 20 minutes, ma'am.
Did you hear what they said?
No, ma'am. Their voices was too low.
Well, he wasn't originally going to trouble you with it, but he was Mary's young man, and she seems very upset about it.
Is she? See, right. Thank you. Here you go, ma'am.
Probably quite a harmless encounter.
Harmless, eh? I think it's about time I had a word with that young lady. Lottie? Lottie?
Excuse me, miss.
Mary, I wanted to talk to you.
Miss, I have a lot of work to do. And there's guests expected in this room.
Oh, Mary, you see Lottie?
She's in there.
Well, what's she doing in there? Lottie? What's this idea about you having young men in your room?
I can explain.
Well, I hope you can.
Well, nothing at all, really. We just came to say goodbye, honest.
Well, you don't have young men alone in your room again. Not ever. Not without asking me first. Is that understood?
Yes.
What do you think you're doing in here?
The room's empty.
You can't go around all the rooms taking vacant position.
Not all rooms, just this one.
Come on, out of here.
No.
You'll do as you're told, young lady.
No, I'm doing no harm. He want me to see his room, he won't mind.
It isn't his room anymore.
It'll always be his room. I don't know how you can have strangers come in here.
Well, I can't wall it up, can I? I've got to earn a living. I don't believe in shrines, and he wouldn't either. What's so special about it, anyway?
I came from it, didn't I? And he died in it from his wounds. And if he'd lived, he'd been blind. Mary told me. I wish you had.
Now, listen, Lottie. I've done my best by you, haven't I? Oh, dear. Didn't want me to start mothering you, did you? Sorry, but I can't do that. It's not in my nature. Now, we found you a good home. He kept his eye on you. And I'll do the same. But you can't ask for anything else.
I remember once, I ran my way home from choir practice. He passed me on his horse. Asked me if I wanted to ride home with him. It was raining and my boots were letting water. He picked me up. And held me tight, and we rode off like a night in a story. We're only a short way. Next day, my dad gave me a new pair of boots. Now it was said, but I knew where they come from. After that, he always smiled at me. He didn't mind me up at Big House, but they always said I shouldn't. I couldn't tell them he wanted me there, because I was. Somehow, I knew I was.
Half is?
But I'm a lady. Brian's bed instead of why. He didn't know, but he could tell, spite of my voice and everything.
Do you want to be a lady? Well, you'll have to learn, then.
Can you teach me?
Well, yes, I could, I suppose. Second hand. But I think it'd be better if you went to school, did it proper.
School?
Yeah, there's one in Switzerland that's very good, I'm told. Where young girls are turned into ladies. I think he'd approve of that.
But leave here?
Well, come home in the holidays, of course.
Be out of your road then, won't I?
Now, that isn't the reason, Lottie. I'm trying to think what's best for you. London's no place for you. Not yet. You feel that yourself, don't you?
No right place for me, sir. Never will be.
Now, that's nonsense.
No. Major were telling me about society and how it works. There's some funny rules. Looks like me don't seem to be part of it.
Now listen, my girl. All my life, society has used me, and I've used it. To my advantage, I'll admit that. But I've never been part of it because I was just a plain, ordinary cook. Well, I was the best, as it happens. But I've never pretended I was anything else. Now you, on the other hand, you can be part of it. Because you're Lord Hazelmere's daughter. Now you can go to this school, learn the rules, and join the game, if you put your mind to it. You can still be true to yourself. You understand what I'm getting at? Oh, blimey, need your father for this. Here, I tell you what. We'll have a glass of wine. Just the two of us, you and me. And drink to his memory. Whoop! Right. That's something I can do for you.
your first glass of wine in his presence. It is your first, I hope.
Yeah.
Yeah. Now, this he would definitely approve of. Here, steady on. This is good stuff, you know.
It's lovely.
This is my girl.
You talk about him.
What do you want to know?
Just how it were, from the beginning, and how it ended. I've got a right to know, haven't I?
Yes, yes, you have. You're quite right. You'll have to wait a bit. You'll hear about it someday, I promise you.
Lovely.
You can have a little nap. With no interruptions. And watch the little flat door.
Very good idea, madam.
No, don't need it. Madam.
Madam? We won't go. It's number 8, the Explorer. Can't get out.
Well, don't come to me. Get Star to do it.
He won't. He says he's too busy.
Oh, just arrived.
By themselves?
The cab driver said there was two ladies, but it seems they disappeared.
Miss Olive Bradford. Who's she?
Lo San. Miss Lottie must have brought a friend back.
You mention in a letter?
Look, I've told you, Pearl.
She says you have to, or she'll knock your bloody block off.
What?
What she said.
Come on, I'll do it.
Which room is it? Number 9. It won't work for me. Come on, give me aims.
Quiet. She's asleep. We'll sneak past. Come on. Whatever you say, my dear. What a quaint old building.
You can trace it back to Charles the First. Some of it.
Can you? Good heavens.
So they say.
Hello. We didn't want to disturb you.
I did recognise you. Nice to see you.
You too. Mrs. Ollie. Miss Olive Bradford, my art teacher. Mrs. Trotter.
How do you do?
Hello.
Poor Ollie. She was going to spend the holes in the Camargue with her brother, but he broke his leg. So I invited her to stay with us. Is that all right?
Well, I should think we could manage it.
Thank you.
Oh, Mum. I am potty about this garden. It's so cloistered, yet wild, and...
The cuckoo?
No, dear, that's one thing it's not.
Yes, well, show Miss...
Ollie.
Ollie, inside, would you? Now start to find a room. I'm having a little rest now, if you'll excuse me.
Come on, Ollie. Let's go find Star. See if he's got our bags and I'll show you.
All right.
No, Pearl. Only 3 of us. Mrs. Trotter, Miss Richards, and myself.
4, I was told.
Oh, were you?
That's right, Major. Miss Lottie's brought a friend back with her. Mrs. Trotter thought you would mind accommodating an extra person.
Oh. No, I suppose not. Oh, yes, that's perfect. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Oh, blimey.
Come in.
Hello.
Welcome home.
Darling Mary. Oh, no, I can't kiss you. I'll smudge. How are you?
I'm very well, thank you. Did you have a nice term?
Oh, it's all right, you know. Rather boring, really. Now, what do you think of my dress?
Well, I think it's lovely.
We spent a day in Paris on the way back, and Ollie bought it for me as a present. Don't tell Mother, though. She might not approve. Have you met Ollie yet?
No.
Oh, you'll love her. She's such fun. She's my best friend. And she also bought me this. Isn't it divine?
Put some on. Go on.
Oh, no, I'll stink the place out. Oh, all right, just a dab. I don't know what the staff will say. Or you and Mother come to that when she sniffs it on you.
Fait accompli.
What?
It's French, meaning too bad.
Mary, we are still friends, aren't we?
Well, of course we are.
It's just that I've never forgiven myself for that wretched time we had over... Oh, heavens, I can't remember his name.
Ryan.
Ryan, yes. Have you found someone else?
No. And to tell you the truth, I haven't really been looking. There's other things in life besides all that, I've decided.
Is there? I think of nothing else. Is that normal?
Well, I think of it sometimes. I'm not quite an old maid.
Yes, but when you were my age, did you think about sex?
Well, I suppose so. Yes, but I didn't let it worry me too much.
The girl I share with at school, Esme, both of us are determined to get engaged this holidays.
Oh, anyone in particular?
Well, he has to be a gentleman.
Oh, of course.
Can you pass me my wrap? Thank you. Okay.
A picture.
Off to the jolly old maid, are then.
Hardly recognise you with your new posh voice.
Yeah, don't you love her? That's what I paint brass for. This is jolly decent of you, Major.
Not at all. Delighted.
Ginger, Miss Bradford.
Oh, do call me Olive. I so hate formality.
Thank you.
Art, you teach, is it?
Yes.
Oh, yes.
Oh, please, come in.
Oh, God, are you all right?
Yes, no, quite all right, thank you. Oh. How's the French coming along, Lottie?
Oh, très bien, merci, monsieur. Madame Chaubert est bien contente avec moi, n'est-ce pas?
Mais certainement. Lottie did splendidly last term. In art, anyway. She drew me an orchid, which I had framed and hung in my room. One of my most engaging pupils.
Flatteuse.
That's nice.
No, thank you.
Are you giving up your singing?
Yes.
With the encouragement of Anatole.
Laissez-vous, s'il vous plaît, mademoiselle.
Anatole?
The ski instructor and a troubadour of some merit.
Divine Anatole.
He used to serenade the girls under their windows in the moonlight until Madame stepped in.
Esme actually climbed out and had to be dragged back by her hair. Poor Esme, she got blisters from the sun and had to spend all Christmas propped up in bed, missing the jollity.
Mm. Lot of jollity, is there?
Oh, yes, since Ollie came. We break all the stuffy rules with Ollie.
Now, Lottie, don't shame me.
Shall I tell about William Tell?
No.
Oh, please. Tell.
Well, Ollie introduced archery into the school briefly and nearly shot an apple off Pamela de Crepney's head. The stupid girl went and wrote home about it. It was a merry old fuss.
Archery was suspended. So was I for a week.
We all protested and threatened to run away, so Madame had to relent.
Mm. Fascinating.
I used to go mountain climbing in Switzerland. Only modest heights, of course. I remember climbing the Dole.
Where's Ruby up there?
I adore mountains. I find them so voluminous, so potent. Do you, Mrs. Trotter?
No, I can't say I've seen him quite in that light before.
I'm very fond of mountains, too. I remember once in Africa, Kilimanjaro.
You've been up Kilimanjaro?
Well, not all the way.
Breathless.
Yes, I was, rather.
Isn't Ollie wonderful? She's led the most amazing life. She ran away to Paris when she was 19 and was an artist's model.
Oh, yes.
Tell about the Polish sculptor.
Mm-mm. Oh, no, no, no.
Go on.
Godiebrzeszka, do you know his work? Vorticism. Pound, Wynton Lewis, just before the war.
Modern, abstract, I think.
Oh, no.
Yes, that's right. Art expressing a seething whirl of ideas. His heads are flat, smooth, almost featureless, but sensual. I'll track some down in London, if you're interested.
Yes, I am most interested. Must have been rather gay, Paris, before the war.
Oh, yes, it's my spiritual home, Paris. La Rive Gauche.
Where's your earthly home?
I'm sorry? Oh, well, actually, I come from Tewkesbury. My father was a colonel in the Indian Army.
Really? But I was out there.
Yes, so I can see.
Bradford.
A dry old stick, much loathed by his men, I hear.
Was he ever in Ahmednagar?
The giant temple.
Oh, and splendid mosques.
And pottery. No, I don't think he was. I remember Bangalore. I was there as a child.
Really, I was there in 92. In fact, I had an rather unfortunate accident. I was pursued by a rogue elephant. Wounded, separated from the herd.
By a mad Portuguese like fury. Poet.
What did you do? Did you shoot him?
He saved because he tripped down some steps and slowed
him
up.
Wasn't that lucky? There is a master painting of an angry elephant by an Indian artist. Do you know what I mean? It must be somewhere in London. I'll find it for you.
She had a breakdown.
But tapes, my happy hunting grounds.
Oh, no, 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 it won't be there. But we'll go there too. We'll have an art binge.
You can go steady on that with her.
Oh, it's all right. We drink wine at school all the time.
I'm sorry, I don't eat meat.
Oh.
I'm so sorry.
Good morning.
Oh.
What a lovely one. A day, I mean.
Yes.
I didn't believe I'd had the pleasure, have I? My name's Howard Glencairn.
Lottie Richards.
How do you do?
How do you do?
Would you care to join me in a glass of champagne?
No, oh, no, thank you. I've got rather a headache this morning.
Forgive me for asking. It's most ungallant of me, but it's not a hangover, is it?
Yes, I think it is.
Look, what you need is one of Mr. Heppel's marvellous potions. Oh, Merriman! Well, will you join me? It's quite shaded at my table.
Thank you.
Sure. Oh, Merriman, one Heppel's breakfast. Soon put you right. Well, at the double, man.
Very good, sir.
Ah. I'm expecting some friends. Well, no, not friends, actually. He's a cousin. He's just got himself engaged, poor fool, to Angela Westbury, whom I expect you know.
No, I don't.
Really? I thought everyone knew Angela. She knows everyone. She's finally sunk her talents into poor old Patrick.
Actually, I've been away for quite a while, in Switzerland, so I've been rather out of touch.
She?
Yes.
It's a bit late in May. Where have you been? Under an avalanche? I was out there myself in February, St. Moritz. I'm surprised we didn't bump into each other.
Well, I've been at school, actually.
School?
Finishing school, at Lausanne.
Good Lord. I thought you were older. Oh, I mean that as a compliment.
I'm 19. Oh, darling. Sorry, we're late.
Angie,
dreary shopping for Papa's birthday.
Did you know he wants his family life inscribed on a piece of parchment of all things?
I can't want to find anyone to do it. Harrods were terribly dodgy.
Apparently there's a little man in the old Kent Road.
Angela, I'd like you to meet Miss Lottie Richards, Lady Angela Westbury, and my cousin Patrick Mellor.
Hello.
How do you do?
How do you do?
You're old Cubby's daughter, are you? Cubby? Sir Cuthbert Richards.
No. Her name's Dorothy. She must be at least 35.
Angela's a walking Debrett, but occasionally some of her pages are missing. No. Miss Richards is at school in Switzerland, Angela.
Oh, you haven't even come out yet.
No, I haven't.
Look here, I'm afraid I started on the champagne, because I couldn't wait.
Hurry along.
All right, take your time. Well, I suppose I ought to offer some formal toast to honor this occasion.
No, please, darling, no speeches.
Oh, dear. Well, to the happy couple.
Cheers.
Yes. Aren't you joining us?
It's remedial.
Oh, I see. A party last night, what?
No, don't touch it. I had it once. It killed me.
Well, you're still here, old thing.
Absolute nonsense. You drink it in one. One, two, three. Down you go.
Well done.
That's it. There you go.
Oh, how do you feel now?
Much better, thanks.
Well, have a gasp to chase it down with.
Thanks.
There we are. All right.
You come from Yorkshire. I knew it the moment you put on that silly accent. Tell me, what are you doing living in this den of iniquity?
Well, actually, my father is a friend of Mrs. Trotter's. Well, he was killed in the war, and she's sort of looking after me.
Oh, how nice.
I can think of nothing nicer than to be looked after by Mrs. Trotter.
No, nor me.
You live here, then?
We just come here for the entertainment,
don't we? What's going on over there, then?
I couldn't say, ma'am. Mr. Blenkard's just ordered a Pebbles breakfast.
Oh, has he? Well, that's no more than she deserves.
Pebbles, Blenkard. Oh, that's
Excuse me, I'm afraid I shall have to go now.
Oh, dear. What a shame. Well, I hope we meet again.
Yes, thank you. Goodbye.
Right.
Bye.
Intriguing girl. Awfully pretty.
Cradle snatcher.
What? Come in.
Am I too early?
Oh, no, please, come in. I rather stupidly mislaid my shoes.
And I left my cigars behind last night. They're in a small gold case. Did you come across them?
No, but please look round. It's rather untidy, I'm afraid.
Oh, no, I love your room. A treasure trove. A man's life spread out.
What? Oh, well, one collects things, you know.
What's this? Your appendix?
No, a present from a Zulu chief. A parting gift, I think.
Something of his?
I didn't inquire too closely. He was rather a fierce fellow.
What's this for?
Oh, nothing. Gymkhana, Quetta, 92.
First prize?
A marvellous pony called Wellington must take some of the credit.
Oh, look, I say. Is that really you? I say. That is impressive.
And you're standing on him.
What? Oh! Oh, look. Only one eye.
That's where I got him, I'm afraid.
I would love you to tell me about it.
Would you?
Well, if you have the time.
Well, it was...
Oh, look! I have found your shoes.
How on earth did they finish up there?
Voodoo. Oh. What a varied life you must have led.
As you have, by your account of things last night.
Oh, God. What did I say?
Oh, nothing untoward, I'm sure you...
Well, one is apt to exaggerate. A little. For the girls, poor darlings. Ah, here are my cigars. Can I tempt you?
Why not? Would you like some coffee?
Can it be conjured up?
In the twinkling of an eye.
Oh, it's beautiful. I'll fetch a vase for it.
He's asked me to go to the theatre with him. On Thursday. Should I accept?
Well, of course you should. Why not? He's a lovely man, Mr. Blenkiron. Quite fancy myself. But you'd better ask your mother just to make sure.
You wanted to see me?
I did. Show the door.
Oh, yes.
Sit down. Now then. Miss Richards. What are you up to?
Well, nothing yet.
Now, look here, Blinkers. I've known you since your father used to bring you here when you were still in your knickerbockers. I'm not saying I didn't take you. Right, little charmer, even in those days. But from my observation, you're all so fickle, feckless, lazy, and fit for nothing much, except for hanging around here, seeing what you can pick up.
Oh, look here, hold your horses, Mrs. T. I mean to say. Well, your assessment of me, as I grant you, fairly near the mark. In fact, you sound exactly like my mother. But I'm not all villain. I met Miss Richards in the garden. I found her charming, and I thought she was fair game.
Fair game?
No, I mean,
Do you know how old she is?
Well, I believe she's 19, isn't she?
And how old are you next birthday?
Me? I'm 28. But good Lord, I know how to behave, and I wouldn't dream of her. And anyway, why are you grilling me like this? I mean, she's
not... Where are you taking her?
To the theatre. To see a play called Love Among the Paint Pots with Owen Nares. Quite suitable from what I've heard.
Well, she might as well go out with a rascal once in her life. So she'll know what to avoid in future. All right. But I want her back here straight after.
What? No supper?
No supper. Back here, 10:30 on the dot. Is that understood?
On my honour, ma'am. Am I dismissed?
Yeah, off you go. In regards to your mother.
Seriously?
When I was a girl, in Tewkesbury, I knew a woman who filled her garden with statues of boys just like these. She was quite young, about my age. She used to talk to them, even feed them, I think. My naughty children, she called them. One day I caught her kissing one and crying. Don't grow up, she said. Don't grow up and leave me.
Touching.
Touched, you mean, very fey. What a way to live.
She was probably quite happy, wasn't she?
Happy? Life isn't talking to stones. It's flesh and blood and sinews and feelings.
Life's a rather hazardous affair, I've always found.
Oh, yes. For you, an adventurer, it must be. If you had £1,000, where would you go tonight?
Up the Amazon.
Would you? Really? Would you take me?
Oh, it's out of the place for a woman, is it?
Well, I'm quite fearless. I could do the cooking.
Yeah. I've always longed to be first on the scene somewhere. Do you know what I mean? To see something that no man has ever seen before.
The Lost World?
Yes. To see and conquer. I'll put down a tiny flag, anyway.
Stake one's claim.
Is that an absurd ambition, do you think?
No. Well, why should it be?
One feels so small in the face of the universe.
Did Columbus, Marco Polo, did Alexander the Great?
Would it be awfully foolish of me to kiss you?
Thank you. It was a lovely play.
Not too gloomy, I hope.
Oh, no, it's so real. Hello, Star. Oh, I'm in love with Owen Nares.
Are you, miss? I heard a funny story about him the other day. Apparently, after a performance, he has a habit of sitting in his dressing room, completely nude, with his feet in the wash basin, giving a charming smile to all his visitors.
Heavens!
I'm sorry, miss. Well, here we are, all safe and sound.
Had a good time?
Marvellous. Owen Nares is simply divine, and Stars just told us that he hasn't...
I think I should say goodnight now.
Won't you stay for coffee?
No, I won't, thanks.
Howard has very sweetly asked me to go on the river with him next week. May I?
It should be rather pleasant if the weather stays fine.
Well, I don't see no objection.
Oh, thank you. You're a Brit.
Good night, Lottie.
Good night, Howard. And thank you again for a lovely evening.
Good night, Mrs. Trotter.
Good night.
Oh, so tired. Straight to bed. Good night.
Good night.
Look, here! What's going on?
Shh.
Quiz your tail shot being here. I'll get the same.
No, you won't. Go behind the screen. Take that off and put this on.
No, I can't, miss.
Do as you're told. Please. I'll make it worth your while.
I'm coming. Get out, I know I will. I'll be on the streets, then what'll happen? I'll be in the road, am I?
Be quiet and please do hurry. Oh, you look beautiful, a princess. Now, put some of this on. Right, hop into bed. Come on, and if anyone comes in, don't say a word. Keep your head well hidden under the bedclothes. I'll be back before morning. You're a real sport, pal.
There's King Carol of Romania over there. They can't very well take his name.
Gracious.
King Carol at all, actually.
He's better off to the safe, isn't
he? I expect he's in a heavy disguise.
Right, well, better okay. Cheers.
Darling, you intrigue me. Tell me something about yourself. What do you want to know? Or something about your family. Is your mother alive?
No, no, she's an orphan. She's old.
Orphans have families somewhere, darling. Who was your father?
Oh, mind your own business.
Oh, you know some question. Surely.
He was nobody very important. I don't think he'd have known you.
He's killed in action, didn't you say?
Where?
Oh, Angela.
But you must know where. I mean, what rank was he? What regiment?
That's a very good question. I mean, he may have been a private.
He
he wasn't. He was a captain. He won the DSO. Beyond that, I don't know very much, I'm afraid. He was away a lot while I was growing up. Stationed abroad.
Now, look, end of subject.
My father was killed in action, at Jutland. And one of his last actions, God bless his dear old heart, was to entrust Patrick and me to an admiral friend of his, as flag lieutenants cruising about in the Med. Part of it all, and yet not part of it.
No stories to tell the grandchildren, no.
Now, darlings, don't let's get maudlin again. It's not your fault you survived.
No, no. But it does cause a kind of lassitude. I mean, most of your friends gone, and aimless days spent in search of what?
A charming compliment to us.
How can we help?
By staying with us and putting us back together.
All the King's horses and all the King's men could put Patrick together again. Will somebody please dance with me?
Yes, I will.
I'll see you soon. Mm. Good night.
What's the racket?
We're not sure.
Pearl's in the suit, whatever it is.
Oh, good. Walking disaster, that girl. No use here. She'll see me and be grave, no mistake. And then she'll trip over the shovel they dug it with.
Mrs. Locke.
The last straw, tell you. You're off at the end of the week. 2 weeks' wages. And that's been generous.
You can't.
And that's for you.
You can't dismiss her. It's my fault, all of it.
See, I told you. She made me drag me by me own for me, mate.
Enough of you. Get out.
No. What? She's innocent. Punish me, not her.
Get away from that door.
I won't. If she goes, I go too, and you'll never see me again.
Don't you never talk to me like that in front of my staff. I don't care who you are. What I do with my staff is my business and my business alone. Now, I've got some talking to do, you and me. Oh, stop sniveling. Right, that's better. Talk in peace and quiet. Now, I don't know what you think your game is.
I'm sorry. Sorry.
Yeah, well, that's not good enough, is it? Broken our trust, that's what you've done. You're beginning to find something. Now, I discover you're nothing more than a common little tart off with the first man that lays his hands on you.
It wasn't like that, hard of gentlemen.
Abducting 19-year-old schoolgirls and carting them up to nightclubs.
I know we were stupid. I know I behaved badly, but I'll do penance. I'll sweep the floors, anything.
You won't see him again. That's your penance.
What?
He's not coming here again. And you can forget about that river trip of yours as well.
Oh, no, please.
Gonna keep a sharp eye on you till you go back to Switzerland, which won't be a moment too soon, as far as I'm concerned. No, I didn't mean that.
You don't love me.
Oh, don't get emotional.
You don't know you want to say that.
Look, I do. I know we don't find it easy to get on with each other, but I do love you, in my way. If your father was here...
I'll keep him out of it. Look, you've punished me, but you won't dismiss Paul, will you?
No.
Please don't.
I'll think about it. Here, just a minute. Suppose you fancy yourself in love with Howard, do you? And you're still a schoolgirl. There's plenty of time for love when you finish learning. You can go to parties.
What does she know about it? We're not going to get married or anything stupid. I just want to be with him. And she's behaving like some Victorian mama in 1880. She lets everyone else do what they like in this hotel except me.
Personally, I think you're a very silly, very immature girl.
What?
If you were my daughter, I would lock you in your room and put you on short rations for a week. She's let you off lightly.
Not you as well. You of all people. Major.
Well, I'm afraid I agree with Miss Bradford. My dear child, you can hardly expect your mother to take any other line, can you?
Oh, you're all the same, you... old people, you don't know anything.
Lottie, come to Ollie. There.
She's full of remorse. Regrets it terribly. Shut herself in her room, crying. Punishment enough, isn't it?
So she sent you to wheel around me, has she?
Not at all. My own initiative entirely.
Yeah, well, I've had a letter from young Blinkers apologising. As only he can. There's something, I suppose.
Oh, splendid. Charming fellow, Hard. Knows how to behave. A bit of an adventure. Calf love, innocent. It's all part of growing up, isn't it?
His father was a good sort. Oh, Reggie.
Salt of the earth, Reggie.
Can't say the same for his mother, though.
Rose is all right when you know how to handle her.
Look, the child has very little time before she goes back. Let her go on the river trip. If it makes you feel any easier, Olive Bradford and I will go along with them. Keep an eye on them.
You and Olive Bradford?
Yes, I'm sure she wouldn't mind giving up an afternoon. She's very fond of Lottie, you know.
Yeah, off the blooming trouble she is.
What?
I pay good money for that school. Stay in the drain if all looking supplies teachers like her. Professional virgins. Filling young girls' heads with tales of Paris and Polish lovers and whatever other rubbish comes in their frustrated imaginations.
Virgins?
No wonder young girls jump out their windows and make fools themselves, frighten their mothers. Good mind to write them, Madame Chambers.
But you can't do that. Most unjustified. I find her quite pleasant. Rather agreeable, actually.
Yeah, I know you do, Major. I've noticed. Now, you want to watch it, because you're just the sort of silly old duffer she's looking for. The last grasp at the rock face before she goes slithering down the slope.
Oh, look here, I can't. This is grossly unfair. She's not like that. You've got a bee in your bonnet, Louisa, and you're letting bitterness cloud your judgment.
No, it's just a friendly warning, that's all.
Yes, well, I resent it. Are you suggesting she isn't truthful about her life?
Oh, no, I wouldn't dream of it, Major. No, you swallow her stories whole. She's swallowing yours, I presume. Yeah, you might make a good match for each other after all.
Oh,
you go on your river trip and enjoy yourself. You only live once, but you keep Lottie in your sights. She's got her life in front of her.
Fancy a race, Major?
What?
She'll give you a start.
No, thank you.
Vanished. We've lost them. I don't understand it.
Do you know what I should like now? A large dish of strawberries and cream.
No, seriously. I'll pledge to Mrs. Trotter. Oh, would you?
Of course I will. And as soon as you're back, you must come and stay with us at Cowes. We have a yacht down there. It's rather fun, especially in regatta week.
Will your mother approve of me?
If she doesn't approve of you, my darling, I'll never get it right.
She sounds awfully fierce.
Not really. I'm sorry you never met my father there. He was a great friend of Mrs. Trotter's. She used to have a house next door to the yacht squadron when he was on the committee. Amazing parties. Him and his cronies. My mother thought they were playing bridge.
Lord Hazelmere?
Charlie? Yes, of course he did. So did I. I used to go sailing with Charlie. He was awfully nice.
He was my father.
What?
And Mrs. Trotter is my mother.
Good God.
Are you shocked?
No, not a bit. What a pedigree.
It's hard to live with.
Yes, I bet it is.
Because no one can ever know. I am a Viscount's daughter.
You are indeed.
So that's all right. Even if the rest is rather awkward.
Well, that sort of thing, it doesn't matter a jot nowadays.
You make a lovely chaperone, you do, Major.
We did our level best, but they spurted ahead.
And quite disappeared.
So what did you do about it?
We made extensive inquiries at the boatyard.
And then we had strawberries and cream.
Oh, did you?
I'm sure they'll be back soon.
Yeah, well, they've been back an hour, it so happens. Came back in Blenker's Bentley. You paddled off on your own, according to them. They couldn't keep up with you.
Oh, don't blame Toby, Mrs. Trotter. It was all my fault.
No, it was my fault entirely.
Oh, no, it was my fault.
It was both your blooming faults, as far as I'm concerned. Still, no harm done, I hope. Let's forget about it.
Look what the wind's blown in. Oh, letter to? Thank you. Can you find a vase for them?
Sorry to wake you, old chap.
No, no, I was reading your book.
Never mind that now. Listen, I have something to tell you. 1,000 miles up the Amazon in an ocean liner, fare from £90.
What?
It's all right. I have a little nest egg my mother left me. The RMS Hildebrand will sail from Liverpool on September 15th. Well, shall we go?
Yes, of course. But won't you be in Switzerland?
I have decided to resign at the end of the coming term. Madame and I have never exactly seen eye to eye. I shan't be missed.
But the girls will miss you, surely. Lottie.
I am to a penny. And Lottie has discovered men, I think.
Yes. Look, I feel there's something I should say about myself. Your image of me as the intrepid explorer.
Yes.
While it might have been true of me 20 years ago, these days, well, anno domini, you know.
You don't want to go up the Amazon?
Not terribly.
Oh, what a relief. I wasn't sure. I had to put it to the test.
You're not disappointed?
No.
It's funny how, when one gets to my age, how the mind plays tricks. One meets a pretty woman and fondly imagines one is younger than one really is. One even feels one is. But of course one isn't.
One would never have guessed the other day on the river.
Well, it's kind of you to say so.
Anyway, age has little to do with it.
I suppose not.
May I ask you a personal question?
By all means.
Why did you never marry?
Oh, quite simply, well, a number of reasons, I suppose. The urge to travel, lack of the right companion, lack of funds. May I ask you the same question?
Quite simply, nobody asked me.
I find that very hard to believe. Oh, I'm so sorry, I'm very rude. Would you like some?
If you don't want to go up the Amazon, where do you want to go?
Well, if you'd really like to know, I've always rather hankered after an old watermill by a stream in Constable country.
Sounds perfect.
But unfortunately, funds precluded.
No, they don't.
She was far too young for him anyway.
Well, I still think it's a pity.
Oh, nonsense, darling. One couldn't have asked them anywhere. Typical of Howard. I despair of him, really, I do.
A millstone?
But of course she is. Louisa Trotter's little bastard. One wonders how many more of them there are. What makes me so cross is the way she tried to deceive us all. As if she could possibly have got away with it.
All right, I'll admit I was a bit harsh the other night. She has got a bit of character. And if I'm honest, I'd rather have her teach Lottie than some crabby old bat who don't know a tip from a toothbrush.
We're, thinking of getting married.
What?
In the autumn. The quiet affair. No fuss.
You bar me?
Yes, I thought you'd say that.
I mean, I'm a little ding-dong's one thing.
There's no need to be vulgar. We've thought about it from all angles, and we're going to do it, whatever you say. Though it would be nice to have your blessing.
You're throwing yourself away.
Oh, hardly. Good Lord. On the contrary, Olive's the one who's doing that, if anybody is. I only hope I'm worthy.
Well, what's she going to live on?
And she has a little money.
Oh, that's handy.
It's not the reason.
Pay the bills, though, won't it?
Well, that's another thing. We're not planning on living here. I've bivvied here for too long, under your kind protection. We're thinking of buying an old watermill.
An old watermill?
By a stream in Suffolk. She'll paint, and I'll fish. We'll come and visit from time to time.
When the fish aren't biting.
Oh, Louisa, I do wish you could be a little more enthusiastic. She really is a poppet. Not unlike you, in some ways. I'm a lucky chap. As you said yourself, it is my life.
Yeah, well... I'm not going to talk you out of it. I hope you'll be very happy.
You're very clumsy, you know. I mean, look at this, what a mess. Oh, I pricked my finger. I don't know you could be so clumsy. I'm the one that has to clear it up.
You're very rude.
Sorry. I don't like working here. Get pushed around all the time. I mean, we're all the same under the skin, aren't we? I'm rude to you because you don't bite my head off, usually. Same way of getting back at him, see? Here, can I have a swipe this?
No, you cannot!
Charming.
I'm not going back to school tomorrow.
Oh, dear. The young man, is it?
Yes. But not for the reason you think.
My dear girl, you've really been behaving very strangely these last few days.
I'm surprised you noticed.
Well, of course I noticed. At my age, love doesn't blind one to anything.
Well, it should, if that's what it is, if that's the word you use.
What is the matter?
Nothing.
Have I done something wrong?
No.
Well, then why aren't you coming back to school?
Sorry, am I interrupting?
She has decided she is not going back to school.
Why not?
I don't know.
You ask her.
Lottie?
It's a waste of time and money. Howard doesn't want to see me anymore, because I told him who I was. He told his friends, and I heard them talking about
me. What friends?
Angela Westbury and...
No, but they're a rotten crowd. You don't want to take any notice of them. Ignore them. But
they matter.
They don't matter to me.
I'm illegitimate. That's the point. Mother wants me to be a lady. But it's impossible.
My dear girl, half the crowned heads of Europe come from the wrong side of the blanket. It's never hindered their progress.
My best friend at school, Laura Duckworth. Papa was a colonel, Mama was a barmaid, and now she's headmistress of a large girls' school in the west of England.
And I know a chap too. I can't mention his name. He's rather well known.
In the cabinet?
In the church, actually. He's a bishop.
Good heavens.
So you see, it's not really a stumbling block. And anyway, your school provides a certain amount of jollity. You said so yourself.
Not if Ollie's not there. If you take her away.
But I shall be there for the next term. We'll have long chats about it. Oh, come on, Lottie, cheer up. We'll go back and bluff it out together, shall we?
Yes. Thank you. Both of you.
Oh, dear. So exhausting, these girls. How did Mrs. Trotter take...
Oh, splendidly in the second sentence. I say, this friend of yours...
Laura Duckworth?
Yes, was that true?
False. The bishop?
Oh, pure fiction.
What a team we make.
Don't bother with that, Miss Redford.
But I insist. How much is it?
May the bill out.
Oh, look, I'll settle that. I'm going to miss the train.
Well, goodbye. Thank you for everything.
Goodbye. Oh, and congratulations, by the way.
Ah, yes. Is it folly, do you think?
No, Tommy settled down.
Are you coming to the station with us?
No, I don't like farewells.
Come on, my dear.
Goodbye. See you in August.
Yeah, hang on a minute. A bit of extra money. Probably need it, knowing you.
Thank you.
Wasn't a bad holiday, was it?
No, it was lovely, thank you.
What about Howard? Is he going to see you off?
No, he had to go up to Scotland.
You never bust up, did you?
Yes, sort of.
Oh, well. Never mind. Plenty more, you'll see. Yeah, I'll come wave you.
Bye, miss. Write to me, won't you?
I remember a train journey once. It was during the Battle of Tel El Kebir.
Save that for a winter evening, Major.
Oh, yes, all right. Are we off then?
Hello, Lottie, darling. Back to school?
Well, have a nice time.
See you when you get back, perhaps. Bye.
Goodbye.
Ah, Merriman. Jug of nectarine punch in the garden when you're ready.
Very good, sir.
I mended it last week, and again just now. We'll put it on one side, then.
So you can put it on my bed, I suppose. So I can put my foot through it and spend a sleepless night trying to sort myself out. Miss Lottie.
More music?
Yes. Oh, what is it now, then? I want some money. Oh, don't we all?
I want some money. Give me some, give me some, give me some, give me some. Do.
Oh, I like that song.
Isn't it funny? The difference.
My parlour, Lottie.
I beg your pardon.
Go to my parlour. I'll have coffee brought through.
But I... Be sure the sheets for the double beds, madam.
Yeah, well, we'll discuss that later. Coffee, Mary. Don't want you hobnobbing with the servants in the dispense, Lottie.
You make me ashamed.
What does that mean?
I don't know. I mean, it's so small to talk like that.
Small?
I mean,
if you're to take your proper place in society, my girl, you don't hobnob with the servants.
Mother, if I'm to take my proper place, as you call it, I would like to have a little money of my own. Not much.
You don't go short.
No, I know I don't. I've got masses of things, but if I could just have a little cash.
I'll give you cash every week.
Yes, pocket money.
And I'll pay for everything
but
you need.
Mother, I... Thank you, Mary.
So what more do you want? What more clothes than I have had?
It's not clothes that I'm worrying about.
Clothes are important. How you look, how you dress. You ought to take your proper place.
Take my proper place in society. Yes, I know. And you're most kind.
Gave you a good education. Cost me the earth.
Yes, and I'm most grateful. I learnt French and how to speak well and how to walk well. And I learnt music. I like music.
Yeah, your father liked music.
Yes, I know. And Mother, I want to sing. I mean, really sing. That's why I want money. I need lessons. I want lessons. I've got the basic instruments, you might say, but I need training and how to put a song over.
How to put a song over? How to sing, you mean?
Yes.
Yeah, all right. All right, all right. You shall have lessons.
Oh, Mother. Oh, you dear, lovely thing.
Yes, well, I'll make inquiries about a teacher.
But
Lady Marshford's girls had a good one.
Lady Marshford?
Yeah, I'll drop a line to Lady Marshford.
But, Mother, it's not that kind of singing. I know, teacher.
It's a nice accomplishment, singing.
Accomplishment?
Very nice for a lady.
A lady?
Leave it to me, Lottie. That's what a mother's for, isn't it?
Trot at home,
star? Oh, yes, Mrs. Leyton.
Parlour?
Yes, the parlour.
Mrs. Leyton, did you say?
Yes, Miss Lottie. Mrs. Trotter's mother.
Ah, oh, thought I knew that name.
There's a kind of rumble when he breathes. So I've got him in bed, and the doctor says to keep him there for a day or two, and he's given him a bottle of medicine to cut the phlegm. But I don't like the look of him, and he's asking for you, so here I am.
What do you want, Lottie?
My music.
Forget your head if it was loose.
Very pretty head, if I may say so.
Thank you.
I was wondering when we was going to be allowed to meet.
This is your grandmother, Lottie.
How do you do?
Yeah, she's got quite a look of me about her.
No, she hasn't.
Oh, yes, she has. My cheekbones. I noticed her in the hall, I thought to myself, I've seen that face somewhere before. When I was younger, of course.
Go and try your music, Lottie.
Oh, please, does she?
Yes, Grandmother.
Takes after your father, eh?
Yes.
Off you go, Lottie.
Oh, let her stay. It's her grandfather who's poorly.
Grandfather? Poorly?
Yes, you do have a grandfather, though I don't suppose you've heard much about him or me.
Lottie!
He's been up and down for a week or two now, and he's asking for your mother.
Yeah, well, I'll come round this afternoon.
Well, may I come too? I'd like to meet my grandfather.
That'd be nice, I'm sure.
Thank you.
Well, quite the little lady, considering.
How are you, Dad?
Oh, fine.
And this is you-know-who?
Lottie.
Yes.
No, don't sit in the bed, Lottie. Not ladylike.
No, no, she's all right there. That's what you used to do, isn't it? Remember?
Yeah. Yeah, I remember.
Sunday mornings, fetching me a cutlery. She used to sit there. Her mother was up, of course.
Of course, making the tea.
And we'd have a nice old chat. I missed her when she went. Little thing she was, too young to leave home, I felt.
Well, I don't seem to be needed here. I'll make the tea, then. We'll have it downstairs. I'll bring yours up, Ern.
Oh, ta. Well, this is a surprise. No, no, don't fuss me, Lou. She keeps on fussing me. If I'm going to die, I want to die in peace.
Oh, Jay, don't talk like that.
Well, it comes to us all. I want mine quiet.
You're darn right.
Yeah, well...
Do you mind if I smoke?
No, not in the sick room.
Of course not. Sorry, Gramps.
No, it's all right. I like a smoke myself sometimes, just occasionally.
Don't swell the smoke around with that chest.
Why'd you keep her hidden so long, Lou?
Well, I'm going out with the tea.
I was pretty once, but I never played me cards right. Never had the right cards to play, got caught up with your dad.
I don't know why you two ever married.
No, he kept bothering.
And no one else asked you?
I felt sorry for him.
Oh, you surprised me.
Yeah. Well, I was surprised. When I woke up one morning, find myself with two babies and a half-baked husband filling my clocks all day.
He loves his clocks.
He loved me once. Or so he said.
Now, I made these parts myself.
Really?
Yeah, well, I couldn't get replacements. It's very old, obsolete, and I couldn't just throw an old friend on one side.
You're very clever, Gramps.
Oh, not really. I know my job. Why Gramps?
Beg your pardon?
Well, why do you call me Gramps? Where'd you get that name from?
Well, yes, it was a girl at that sick-making finishing school.
Oh, I thought it might have been your own idea. Now, you see that little wheel
there?
She
was very fond of her grandfather. She used to talk about him. I wished I had one.
Well, you've got one.
I have now. He was very good to her. He used to send her money and...
Oh?
Her father was killed in the war.
Oh, I see. Well, all this Gramps has got is clocks.
Yes. Can I look at another one, please?
Well, let me do this up first, eh?
She's got money.
She? Oh, your mother.
She's got money for my father as well as all her own.
Yeah, well, she's comfortable. She's... done very well.
Do you know how much she gives me?
Really no idea.
A measly £2.
A week?
Yes, pocket money.
Well, that's not bad for pocket money. I started work on a little more than that.
Yes, but times have changed, Gramps. I mean, it's too darn silly, £2 a week.
Well,
I'm 22, Gramps. 22.
Well, you could take a job.
She won't let me. She treats me like a child.
See you, sir. Sir and madam.
Let me help you, Grandmother.
Oh, there's a kind girl.
Shall I pour you a cup, Gramps?
Oh, tough.
Quite a little nurse, ain't she?
I like to be useful.
Yours is downstairs, Lottie.
I think I'll stay with Gramps. Sugar?
Thank you, dear.
2 seconds and a fourth. I don't know, Fred, we don't seem to be having much luck with the horses this summer. We need the Major to tell us what not to break. Morning, Colonel.
I'll be in the Turkish baths if anyone wants me.
Very good, then.
I'll get Colonel right away to clear up the mess. All night party, number 7, Mr. Starbuck. Oh.
Miss Richards, not bad at all.
Thank you, Mr. Summers.
You know, you've got a voice. I mean, a voice.
I know, Mr. Summers.
Nick Summers?
Hello, Nick. I'm Lottie. I thought you'd be so horribly stuffy.
Me?
When you arrived last week, you were quite a shock.
Really?
Mother engaged you.
Yeah, that's right.
On Lady Marshford's recommendation. She's awful.
Well, she knew my uncle. He taught her daughters, you see, and me, incidentally.
Ah, so where is he now?
Retired. Recommended me instead. Sick of untalented, empty-headed, silly girl, he says.
Oh?
I quite readied you.
Hey.
But I needed the cash in your... Well, you're...
And not silly.
No.
Nor empty-headed.
No.
And certainly very, very talented.
Heavens, yes! Listen, I need you.
So soon.
Now clear your mind, little Lottie.
You've confused it totally.
Poor Dotty Lottie. Now, I write songs, you see.
Clever boy.
For review.
Ah, a slight interest dawns in my snowy breast.
They're good songs.
Who says so?
I say so. So will you when you sing them.
Young man, you presume too much. I'm a born actress, you see.
Yes. But with your personality and the way you look...
No.
Oh, come on, you look lovely and you know it. And you move like an angel. Oh, baby, we can do a lot together.
Purely business, of course.
Oh, purely business, baby.
But will it make me money, baby?
Ah, more than you dream of.
That's impossible.
Ah, ambitious too, eh? When do we start?
Now. Let us not delay the delightful hour.
Hey, Mother?
Out. Ah. Visiting the sick.
Let's release. Tootsie, goodbye.
Tootsie, no cry. The choo-choo train that takes me away from you. No words can say how sad it makes me. Kiss me, Tootsie, and then do it over again. Wait for the mail, I'll never fail. If you don't get a letter, then you'll know I'm in jail. Ta-ta, Tootsie, don't cry. Choo-choo, Tootsie, goodbye.
Party's still going on, sir?
No, madam. Colonel Fitzsimmons said he's gone to the...
going on. Oh, for that piano, you impudent young.
I asked him to.
Out!
No, don't go.
I'm very sorry.
I asked you here to teach my daughter to sing.
That's what I'm
you call that singing? That disgusting...
Oh, listen to me!
You're sacked!
You can't sack him.
I shall write to Lady Marshall and tell you not to be trusted.
Oh, Mother!
I assure you it was all entirely my fault.
No, out!
Oh, you wicked girl.
Wicked? You're mad.
Mad, me? Mad? I'll do my best for you and you turn around to play these tricks with half-baked young men.
How dare you? Nick is my friend.
Well, he's not anymore.
You silly old cow.
Lottie.
Don't pretend to be shocked. You've a fair turn of language yourself if you fancy it. I've heard about you and your tongue.
Oh, I do.
And if you don't like my friends...
I like your other friends.
Yes, those you choose for me. Well, in future I shall choose them for myself. And if you don't like them and what I do, you can give me my money and I'll find a home of my own.
Your home is here and I'm responsible for you. And as for your money...
It comes to me by the grace of God and Louisa Trotteray. Well, it's not good enough.
I know what's left for you. What your father would want.
He'd want me to be myself, not some dressed-up maypole carted about in the marriage market, pretending to be a lady.
You are a lady.
I'm a bloody little bastard from Yorkshire.
Don't you talk to me like that.
Well, why didn't you leave me there? At least I was a person. At least I knew my place. At least I had some bloody shreds of dignity instead of parading about here by your
leave. Stop it, Lottie.
I am going to be a singer. I'm going to be a star, and you won't stop me. I shall never marry. I shall never be part of your stupid dreams. I've got my own dreams. I'll be true to them. If I starve, I'll be true to them.
Lottie!
Oh, Jolly love, I need you now. What it boils down to is... I don't feel like a mother. Don't really feel as if she was anything to do with me, in a sort of way. I mean, I worry about her. I want her to be happy.
Then make her happy.
Hey?
Give her enough money to be independent.
I'm afraid to, Dad.
Afraid? Of little Lottie?
You don't know her.
Have I? Know her mother. And her grandmother. And you can't tell me her father was a wastrel.
No.
Well, she's no fool. Our little Lottie.
I only met her once.
Oh, she's been here a couple of times since.
I didn't know. What's she after? Didn't give her money.
I was always one for a pretty woman, Louisa.
Oh, don't give her money, Dad. She gets her hands on money. God knows where she'll end up.
Violet looks after the money. I flatter myself your daughter comes here because she likes her cramps.
Yeah, I wouldn't bet on it. She's deep. I can't fathom her. I want to help her. Dad? Dad? You're feeling better, aren't you?
Oh, yeah.
Mum said she was on the mend.
Yeah, well, she's stuffing me full of binges and all that, so how can I fail to mend?
I feel like the whole world is emptying.
Emptying?
The people I love. Dear Major.
We were only playing the piano and singing one of Nick's songs. They're good songs. But she's so old-fashioned. She's so wrapped up in herself. I can't move. I can't do anything without asking her, without her approval. I'm a grown woman. She doesn't see me at all. She just sees what she wants me to be.
Lottie, come here. There, on your little perch, eh?
Perch is the right word. I'm just a damn silly bird in a golden cage.
Shush now, shush. Your mother cares for you, worries over you.
No. I'm glad I found you.
Yeah. Yeah. Little late in the day.
I shall have to get away from there. Get clear of her and that hotel. I hate that hotel.
You mustn't do anything foolish.
You can't do anything foolish without money, Gramps.
There's a modicum of truth in that remark, I suppose. Although there is such a thing as being driven to a life of sin through want. Well. So, you want to be a singer?
I've got a voice. I know that. I've got the right personality. I know that. When I get up and sing, I know how to put it over. I know what to do on stage. I just know. It's sort of instinct. But I have to develop my voice. I need technique, proper breathing and all that. I need lessons from a decent teacher. I need money. Nick can't afford to go on.
Have you told your mother all this?
She won't begin to listen.
Well, she should understand.
She doesn't want to understand me.
Can't you earn this money?
It would take so long. I need to be starting now, while I'm young and attractive. It's youth that counts.
I see.
In a few years, I shall have wrinkles. Oh, God, it's all too damn sick-making.
Well, don't swear. I don't care to hear you swear.
Sorry, Gramps. Nick could help me, but he's got no money. I can't ask him.
You see that clock over there? Bring it here, will you? Here, girl. Open the back. Move the little catch. Right, then. Close it and put it back, please. £78.10, little Lottie.
What?
Will that help with the lessons?
Gramps.
I was saving it for a little holiday.
Take it, I can't.
You can, and you will.
Oh, Gramps, well, I'm horrible, horrible. I come here worrying you.
Naughty girl, eh?
So sorry.
Shush now.
This money, your holiday.
No chance now.
Might make you better.
£78.10, saved over the years. Put it away. Use it well, my little love. Spread your wings.
This holiday.
One of those dreams that make the world go round.
When I'm rich.
I was thinking of a sort of little cruise. I had an idea of going to sea when I was a boy. One of those silly, childish ideas. But I was apprenticed to a clockmaker. Sitting at a bench all day long. Little room, pokey and stuffy. Full of clocks. All ticking.
But you love clocks.
They grew on me, you might say.
Gramps, when I'm rich, you shall cruise all round the world.
So when I come in, I made him his benches and a bit of bread and butter and took it up. He was lying back on his pillow, staring out, dead as a doornail. and holding fast to her hand. I had a job to break his grip. She never turned an hair. Looked pale, all eyes. How long's it been like this, I said. Since morning, she said. You could have knocked me back with a feather. And you sat there like this all that time, I said. I couldn't leave him, she said. Could I? Bear thinking about. I mean, at her age, holding hands with a corpse all day. She's got guts. I'll say that for her. Well, now, a new life begins.
What exactly does that mean?
Well, I suppose it means I'll be on my own.
Are you sorry, Grandmother?
No. To be honest, no.
Well, I shall miss him. Poor Dad.
Poor? He had a good life, by and large. Was Arthur the one who got cut off in his prime? God rest him. I take it that you'll keep up my allowance, Louisa.
Why is it always money?
Because it buys things.
You're pretty sharp with the pennies yourself, Louisa. First, I shall have a little holiday.
Paid for by me?
No. Ernest had a bit put by, I know. I shan't ask you for any more than I've a right to.
A right?
Well, I'm your mother. I mean, I don't mean as much to you as your father did, but I am your mother. No, I'll play fair. I shall let a couple of rooms.
You're going to take in lodgers?
Paying guests. Should do well. Give him breakfast, evening meal. Sort of little Bentinck, as you might say. He's helped me back, you know. There's a lot of things I might have done if I hadn't married him.
Marriage is just too silly. I mean, two people tied to each other for life, come rain, come snow. It's just too silly.
Well, now we know where you're heading.
If you like.
No, I don't like.
Come off it, Louisa. She's as much right to think for herself as you have. Your mother went her own way. Nothing I said ever stopped her. More tea, Louisa?
No, thanks. I've got to go. Can't dilly-dally around here all day.
Let me know if there's anything of his you want. I'm selling his clocks.
You what?
Well, no good clinging to the dead. And I can't go winding up that lot every night, can I? Some of them are quite valuable.
I'd like that one on the chest in your bedroom. We used to wind it together when I was a kid. Only one I could manage the terms. Poor Dad.
Don't keep saying that.
Might I have his watch?
Not worth much.
Not to sell. He showed me its works. He made them.
Lottie.
I'll get them now. No use in hanging about.
I've got no one, though.
You've got me?
No.
Lottie.
Oh, no.
It's gone.
What was that then?
No. £78.10 in the back of his ear clock. He was saving it up. He used to put in a bit every Friday. Went up there after giving me housekeeping. I know he did. And I used to count it when he was at work. I counted on the Tuesday before he passed over when he was asleep. I haven't touched it since then. I mean, it didn't seem right with him laying there all cold, so where is it? He can't have taken it with him, can he? I mean, I laid him out. He only got Tom's Aiden in the back pocket of his best trousers, so where is it? But he's in it somewhere. He'll take this and this. I'm going through his things. Oh, it's a good job I ain't sold no clocks nor sent his clothes off. In the space of 3 weeks, he's come and gone.
Oh, hell. Mrs. Trotter will miss him.
Will she?
They're very close.
She never said. She never told me. She never tells me anything. Why didn't she take me to see him sooner? If she really is my mother, then...
Oh, she's dead, all right. She wouldn't tie herself to such knots over a stranger.
Knots? You come on, Auntie Gwynne. Do your stuff.
There, now. I've never seen a cup like that before.
Really?
So profuse.
Profuse? She means a lot of tea leaves.
No, flowers, masses of flowers springing up from the dark earth.
Romantic.
And all there for your picking, Miss Richards. Oh, a life full of flowers. Great bunches of flowers. Your arms full of flowers.
You're going to be a film star, Miss Lottie. Oh, no, it's the stage for me. I'll get a date up north, perhaps, with Nick, and we'll try a few things out.
Oh, I wouldn't do that if I were you.
Hey?
No. Start at the top, where you belong. You've got to learn to think big thoughts, girl. The theatre's for big people.
My God, you're darn right. Well, I'll do it. I'll show them all.
You still up to your old tricks, Mrs. Davis? Thought you'd have run out of that rubbish by now. I don't mind what you do in your own time, but when you're here, your time is mine. I pay for it. Up it, Lottie. Mary, don't encourage the girl to come in here.
They seem to be making the glasses smaller now, don't
you? Place hasn't changed much, Major.
No, nor never will.
Fred's a bit older.
Hello, Fred, old girl. Lottie.
Major.
Let me look at you.
Yeah, well, I can look at her later on. Refreshments for the Major in my room, start.
Madam.
I'm glad to see you, Major.
Well, I was struck camp the moment I got your letter.
Mary's put you in your old room.
Oh, splendid.
Sit down, Major. You're tired.
And you look pale. Very pale and drained.
Dad died.
Is that why you asked me to come?
No, he died after I wrote you. Everything happens at once. What's wrong with me?
Wrong?
What's missing?
Well,
something's missing.
I wouldn't have thought.
Some vital part. I just don't see my... Oh, I don't know.
No. I'm sorry about your father.
Yeah, well... I loved him, didn't I?
Oh, I would have thought so. Nice travelling.
And I loved Charlie.
Yes.
So what are my feelings for Lottie?
Happy ones, sir.
I can't fathom them. You had a daughter. What would you expect of her?
There's the rub. Nothing if I could possibly help myself. What do you expect of Lottie?
Everything. Or do I?
You are, of course, a very single-minded woman. Oh, yes, my dear, you've done a lot for me, a lot for other people, given a lot, helped. But only when it fitted with your ideas of people and behaviour.
Yeah, well, no, I'm a snob.
A form of selfishness, if you think about it.
I don't know. I want the best for Lottie.
The cry of every parent I've ever known.
I try to think what Charlie would want.
Always remember this, my dear. Charlie was not concerned with convention. And neither are you. Lottie has her right to be the same.
Coming on. There's quality there.
I know.
Vanity, vanity.
It's not vanity, I just sort of know.
Oh, you're going to be a riot, my little Lottie.
Careful.
What?
I'm not yours.
Oh, you know what I mean.
Perhaps. But I'm taking no chances. We've set our boundaries and we stick to them.
I'm sorry, Lottie. I'll be more careful in future. It wouldn't work out with me anyway.
Oh, that's all right then. I don't want any ties. I want to be free. I don't want to be...
Now, don't get hard, my love. You'll take a lot of knocks. Unless I'm losing your granddad, don't get hard. An artist must be vulnerable, or he's no use to man nor beast.
You sound like an old man.
As old as the hills.
I shall have to find somewhere else to live.
I should have thought the Bendigo Hotel
was... It's too humiliating.
To live and is full of misery. He cometh up and is cut down.
Seen a ghost? No such luck. Lottie! Grandmother, that money, that £78.10, I've got it.
What?
I've got it. Gramps gave it to me just before he died.
Oh, the cheek. The damn cheek giving away my money.
It wasn't really your money.
Well, it was my husband. What's his was mine. How do I know he gave it to you?
I've told you.
How do I know it's the truth?
You believe what you like.
Yes. It's the truth.
Yes. He gave it to me to pay for singing lessons.
Singing lessons? Did your mother know?
No.
No, I didn't think she would. So?
I'd like to give half of it to you.
Oh, very generous, I'm sure.
No, not generous. Not really. I want to be a lodger.
Here?
Yes. I want to work in my own way, and Mother won't let me.
What sort of work?
The theatre.
Oh, my God. Worst one in the eye for your mother.
I've got talent.
Yes.
No joking. Please believe in me, Granny.
Granny. Have a toffee.
We need a banker star. What about Polly Wally Doodle in the 415?
surprised at you, Major, begging a favour.
Well, you know, I've been out of touch with the form.
Sorry to see you go, miss.
I shan't forget you, sir. Or you, Fred.
Cap?
Thank you.
Good luck. I'm sure you're doing the right thing. If you need Olive and me, you know where to find us. Bless you.
Mary, will you see that my trunk is sent on?
This is a better trunk.
Didn't I tell you? I'm moving out.
How are you?
It doesn't suit me here.
Cab's waiting, miss.
Thank you, sir.
Then it can go on waiting. On the way with Lottie. In here.
I haven't time.
Then you'll bloody well make time.
No.
Don't you know me?
I've made certain arrangements and I shall stick to them.
So have I made arrangements.
Please take my bags, Star.
Don't no one touch them bags.
Allow me.
Major.
I'm sorry, but...
Oh, good morning. Lovely day, isn't it? Seen her off, have you?
I saw her into a cab.
Fine friend you are. Where was she headed?
I didn't ask her destination.
And you should have.
I had no right to ask such a thing. She's over 21. She's entitled to a little...
Like hell she is.
Louisa, I think you're behaving very badly. You're fond enough of independence yourself.
I asked you here to help me.
That's what I'm trying to do.
Not very hard.
You know she must have freedom. A high-spirited girl like Lottie.
Yeah, well, I'm frightened for her. I want her to be free to go out and be a success. Frightened.
Sure it's fear?
I don't know. Am I jealous?
Perhaps you resent... That is, you had such a struggle yourself in those early days.
Yeah, well, certainly wasn't roses all the way. Oh, I don't know what it is. I can't get close to her. Don't even know if I want to get close to her. Don't even know if I like her. Anyway, she's gone. God knows where. My only feeling about it is that if anything happens to it, it'd be my fault. Oh, God. Wish Dad hadn't died. I'm sick of feeling guilty. I didn't ask for a daughter, did I?
Oh, really, Louisa?
She makes no effort. She makes no effort at all to understand me.
You can't expect the young to understand.
Damn the young. Why should they have it all their own way?
Well, unfortunately, they don't. Poor things. If you ask me, the boot's on the other foot.
What exactly do you mean by that?
If you really want to know, Louisa, I think you're the one who's making no effort to understand. Quite frankly, you're being damned pig-headed about the whole thing.
Now,
and don't interrupt me. I've come up to London because you asked me to. It wasn't convenient. Olive was quite shirty about it, as a matter of fact, so you jolly well hear me out. As you're fond of telling us, you spent a lot of time and money trying to make Lottie into a lady. But can't you see you're pushing a square peg into a round hole? Damn it all, you're an intelligent woman. You must see that Lottie has no intention of ever being this lady you dream about. She wants to be herself. Of course, you see it. In your heart, you know that Lottie is right. But you can't admit you're wrong, can you? You just cannot admit it. Which, my dear, is why you're feeling guilty, because you are guilty of coercion. Louisa, if you're not very, very careful, you lose the only daughter you ever had.
Well, for those kind words, many thanks.
I'm right, though, aren't I?
Seems everyone's right but me. Well, I think we deserve a drink. I certainly need one.
Brandy, sir.
Being damn stingy with the brandy, Merriman.
Oh, sorry,
bring
Colonel.
The bottle there, heaven's sake.
Very good, Colonel.
No, sure. Leave that one.
Here. What's your temper like this morning?
Mrs. Trotter, I take it, you mean?
Very well, sir, the temper in this place. Don't know what's going to the woman lately. Frying off the alley so much as bleak an eyelid.
If you was to ask Fred that question, I rather think the reply would be that she's weighed down by the joys of motherhood.
Oh.
Isn't that right, Fred?
Your coffee, madam. The new blend you suggested.
Mary, have you heard from Lottie? You have.
I had a little note last week.
See?
She's all right.
And you know where she is, of course. Sworn to secrecy. Well, I'm only a mother. I can't be expected to be told the whereabouts of my only daughter.
I'm sure that...
Yes, so am I, Mary. Well, I suppose I'll hear soon enough if she's starving.
She's not starving. Well, I'm sure she won't... I mean...
Yes, what do you mean?
Just, she's clever and...
And she's beautiful.
Well, yes.
So she'll never go short of protectors, will she?
I've just come to tidy him up a bit.
Well, seems that we're more attentive to his grave than we were to him.
I was a good wife to him. I saw to his every need. He was the one who... Oh, well. He's dead now. You're selfish, Louisa.
Yeah, someone else did that to me.
I missed him at first. Quite missed him sitting in the kitchen with his clocks. Funny man. Secretive. Oh, well. I'm all right now.
Seem forgotten, eh?
I don't mean that. I mean I got something to live for now.
Oh, that's nice.
It's the first time in my life that I'm doing something that I really enjoy.
Good-looking lodger, eh?
Well, you could say that. You coming home for a cup of tea? I need to talk to you.
No, I'd rather not.
Lottie's moved in with me. I'll put the kettle on.
She's made a difference here.
She's young.
Never lay off for me, set foot in here. Kept it like a church.
Well, I'd have something, didn't I? Somewhere where I could shut the door, be by myself, feel nice. You'll have to let me have more money, Louisa.
I thought that was coming.
Well, Lottie needs things, clothes and all that.
Thought some lover was keeping her.
Oh, no.
So she's got round you, is she?
We have an arrangement, Louisa.
Of which I am the operative part.
Lottie doesn't know I'm asking you for brass, as she calls it.
No, she knows you will.
No, she'd be angry if she knew. She's talented.
Oh, yeah, she's talented.
Now, don't be bitter, Louisa. You spoil your looks. She can sing and she can act.
How do you know?
Because I've heard her practicing in here. Reminds me of you in your happy moods. Now, I can keep her in food and all that. I've got a nice young woman in the room above. Very clever girl, shorthand typist, and she pays up regular. But Lottie needs clothes, good clothes. Well, after all, it's herself she's selling. And she needs dancing lessons. You can't do nothing by halves in the world of entertainment.
You seem to know a lot about it.
I'd have liked to have had a go myself.
Where's that cup of tea?
She's singing in a smart place this week. It's her first job. She's earning good money. You go and hear her, Louisa. She's your daughter. And she's going to the top. I've heard them start on yours. You can always tell the ones who are going to the top. She won't be living here much longer. I never understood you, Louisa. But I understand Lottie.
And the usual.
Yes.
There was some talk of a coach. I know for certain she's bought a new hat for Derby Day. Excuse me, Major, I must go. We're very busy. Yes, I will. Afternoon, Miss.
Hello, staff. I'm my little friend. I've got a little gift for Fred.
Oh, thank you, Miss. Oh, Fred will be pleased.
your usual dish?
Oh, thank you kindly, Merriman. With lemon.
Oh, of course, Miss.
Fred's most appreciative, Miss.
Oh, good. She's the most discriminating young lady. Oh, Star, I should be obliged if you could mention the usual little matter to Mrs. Trotter.
Of course, Miss. Telephone call from the Major, madam.
Oh?
He's coming up to stay for a few days, if that will be convenient.
Oh, no. Yeah, no. We'll have to have a double.
Mrs. Smith-Barton will not be accompanying, madam. She's taking part in an expedition of an artistic nature to Florence.
Oh, no, that wouldn't suit the Major. So he's coming up for a bit of racing, is he?
Ipsum, yes. I don't believe Mrs. Smith-Barton appreciates the Major's interest in the sport of kings.
No, neither does her housekeeping money, shouldn't wonder. So, while the cat's away...
Exactly, madam.
Oh, well, nice to see the old codger. They can have his old room.
Yes. There is another matter.
Yeah, and I know what it is. And the answer's no. No, no! Get that in your thick head once and for all!
Madam, the lady's been very patient.
Yes, she's been that all right. Must have been here 30 days in the last month already.
You're a very charming woman.
Just chuck her out, like I told you.
You can hardly do that, madam. The lady's a very nice person and American. If you could just have one word
with her. Look, Star, the front hall is your affair, not mine. I don't like writers. Especially lady writers, they're all strippers and gossips, and that's that.
Miss Applegate seems very determined and persistent.
And so am I, Star. I'm engaged, and I'll always be engaged.
Yes, madam.
You can tell her from me, bribery and corruption will get her nowhere. The way to my heart isn't through Fred's stomach.
Yes, madam.
Oh, that's fine. Thank you, Merriman. Going in for any competitions this week?
Yeah, well, Miss Thorne, I might have another try at trumps in tidbits. Mm-hmm. Rather a teaser, Miss. Your advice would be invaluable, you being an expert in such matters, you might say. I was wondering about matchmaking, Miss.
Hey, how about a burning question?
Oh, very good, Miss.
Top flat. Lofty aspirations?
Oh, very droll. Very nice, Miss. Thank you.
No go.
I'm sorry, Miss. I know Mrs. Trotter of old. I'm afraid you're wasting your time.
Thank you, Star.
Excuse me.
Captain,
no, thank you, Star. Lord Elphick's just got a lovely new Bentley.
Congratulations.
I say, let's go for a race to somewhere completely obscure.
Like Pup
or Dolly's Hill.
Have a lovely smash on the way.
Mrs. Trotter.
Look, this room's private. Will you please go?
Of course, but before I do, I just want to thank you. Your hotel is really the most delightful place in London. And this room, the photographs, the beautiful decor, is just perfect. Exactly as Larry described it to me.
Who's Larry?
Larry Rickenbacker. He's my cousin.
Oh, Ricky Tick is your cousin, is he?
Yeah, he told me all about you. What a truly beautiful, kind person you were.
Yeah, well, I am to some and not to others. Your cousin happens to be a brave airman and a polo player and a gentleman. You happen to be a scribbler. I don't like scribblers, especially female American ones.
Oh, but it was Larry who suggested that I came over to see you. I mean, your name is quite a household word in the States.
Yeah, well, it ain't here. I'm private and exclusive, like this hotel, and that excludes you.
Oh, I meant only for a few households, just the best, the very few, your old friends. I mean, they wanted...
Yeah, what do they want?
They want me to write a little book for them. Nothing to do with newspapers, about you and your hotel setting down all your great successes and wonderful memories. They think you owe it to history.
I don't owe nothing to history.
Well, what I really meant
was... How would you do that, then?
What?
Where would you make this book?
Well, whenever you've got a few moments free, you could just tell me about your life, and I'll write it all down for you.
And how would you do that? I talk like I've got verbal diarrhea. What was that done?
Oh, I can write in shorthand, 100 words a minute.
Yeah, well... I'd have to read it, you know, before it was printed, see if I liked it.
Oh, of course, Mrs. Trotter. I'd write it all out for you. You must agree to every word. That would be part of the bargain.
Bargain, eh? So it's bargain time, is it? When do you want to start?
Today? Now?
Oh, no, I'm too busy. Say tomorrow evening, when things are a bit quieter. Everyone's nice and comfy after they've dined.
Oh, thank you, Mrs. Trotter. It'll give all your friends so much pleasure to have such a lovely souvenir.
Here, hang on, I'm not gone yet, you know. Miss Apple Blossom, whatever your name is.
Applegate.
Well, I never thought she would. I wouldn't have given 10 to 1. I don't know how she did it.
Mrs. Trotter's always had a soft spot for Americans, but not ladies, nor journalists.
She's got a good head on her shoulders, that young lady Braggs.
I reckon you could strike matches on both of them, I mean.
Oh, Mr. Starr, anything to say?
Just going off the post, if you keep your eye on things, lady.
Well, I'll post it with the rest of the mail.
Oh, prefer to do it myself.
Getting senile, that's his trouble.
It's his titbits competition, he's very particular.
No, he's going a bit upstairs, if you ask me. Fred and me was thinking of taking a little stroll in St. James's Park a bit later on, it being a nice evening. Fred still has a regrettable tendency to chase the ducks, and we thought the restraining influence of another female might,
All right, Fred, that would be nice. We could chase the ducks together.
Boy. Boy!
Coming. Start his career out east.
Evening, Star.
Evening.
Good evening, Fred. I have an appointment with Mrs. Trotter, so I'll just go
in. I'm sorry, Miss. Mrs. Trotter isn't here.
But we made a date.
I imagine, Miss, that Mrs. Trotter's been unavoidably detained.
She's gone off down to an house party near Epsom for the racing.
Here, don't you go swiping no more of my nectarines, Mr. Merriman.
Need a couple for Sir Roddy's punch.
He must have the stuff coming out of his ears. You get your only future, though, we're sure to Covent Garden this morning.
Perhaps if you was up a little earlier.
Put that back. You can have one and that's all. I need the rest for tomorrow's luncheon. What that millionaire's giving for my Fontainebleau surprise.
Jumped up parvenu, profiteer. Give him 10 wood notes the difference.
No, but Mrs. Trotter will.
Yeah, that woman needs shooting.
Mr. Merriman.
Well, makes an appointment, Miss Applegate, then runs off to a racing friend without so much as a word of apology.
You won't get her to change her spots.
There's more of them than there was. Seems to think she's the Queen of Sheba. Yeah, she'd have this hotel coming out around her ears one of these days. Go about my words.
I think it's terrible the way Mr. Merriman pinches her nectarines. Bruises them all.
I'll pinch him if he comes down here again stealing my fruit.
Don't think you could, Mrs. Buckles.
Could what?
Pinch Mr. Merriman. He's all hard and dried up, like an Egyptian mummy.
Now, just you finish off what you're doing and get up to bed. And stop passing remarks.
Yes, Mrs. Buckles.
We bet 4 winners, Stout Major and me. Bet 4 winners.
Congratulations, madam. Yeah. Which horses, Major?
Oh, you know. Yeah, well, all I know was the loves one was so drunk I could hardly see him. Do you want to ask the one, Major?
Excuse me, madam. The American lady's been waiting since yesterday.
Who?
Miss Applegate?
Applebum? Never heard of her. Oh, hello, dearie. Major, this is Miss Apple something or other. She's Ricky Ticky's sister. Do you remember him? He was the one that climbed the lamppost and imitated Big Ben. Oh. Come along then, dearie. We'll have a glass of wine.
Nectarine punch!
Oh, don't want to worry about him. That's Romy. When he's not here, he's going in the West Indies. His suit's a bit rumble because his tailor can't pay his rent, so he takes it out of Ronnie's clothes.
Oh, I say. Put a monkey on crossbow for me, would you?
I'm afraid the derby's been run, Sir Ronald, on Wednesday.
Oh? Oh, disappointing.
And that was a board school and a penny a week. I wanted to be a schoolmarm. But my parents shoved me out scrubbing and cleaning for a lot of nobodies and nothing a year, and that was no good. Oh, pardon. I mean, can't live like that, can you? Just eating and sleeping. No, I had to get among the knobs. My family didn't know what earls and dukes and lords and ladies was, but I did. So I taught myself to cook. You've got to be something menial in this life if you're going to get to know those sort of people, if you're born in my position, which was no position at all. And in one day, I got the chance to cook a meal for him.
Oh?
Prince of Wales, as he was then.
When was that?
Oh, 500 years ago, I should think. He gave me a sovereign as a reward. Here we are. Have a look at this. There. So you can see the teeth marks on it where I bit it every night for luck. I was that ambitious. I wanted to be the best cook in England. That's what I became. Even Monsieur Scoffier himself said that about me. And before the war, cooking was even more important than clothes. Oh, yeah, I'll cook for anyone who was anyone. The king, the czar, the kaiser. He liked fruits, kaiser. He used to eat the funny little fool because of his withered arm. Oh. Gave me a medal, took me out in his yacht. There you are. Have a look at them.
Highcliff Castle, Londonderry House, Buckingham Palace. My, oh, my. And what lovely names. Pièce de Boeuf Angelé on Bellevue. Pêche Rose de Mai.
Yeah, it tasted even better than they sounded.
And the number of the courses, 7, 8, 9?
Yeah, sometimes 10 or 11.
How could they eat so much?
Oh, they had great big stomachs in them days. The ladies had great big tits. Breasts. Something you really built a dress around, not flat little nothings like the girls have today.
What did the king like best of all your dishes?
The quail pudding. I had to cook that for him everywhere he went. There you are. There's the recipe. Have a look at that.
Take your quails or snipe and truss for braising. Leave in marinade here, 2 hours.
I'll cook it for you tomorrow for your lunch. Oh, quick one. So you line a basin with ordinary suet crust. Yeah. And then you wrap your quail in slices of beef cut as thin as paper. Takes a bit of doing it. And the beef will dissolve in the sauce when it's cooked.
What's the secret of your cooking?
Common sense. What do you say, Ethel?
I don't know, Mrs. Trotter.
Yes, you do. What about vegetables?
Well, you always have to pick the best of what's in season. Even potatoes. Now, they've just got to be perfect. Right, Michael. Michael.
Angelo.
Michael Angelo. Always.
Yeah, well, forget that, sir. What about meat, Mrs. C?
Oh, cook it natural. Don't mess about with sauces and that like they do abroad. I mean, a grilled chuck should stand or fall on the flavour coming from its own juice.
Yeah, the old French chef who taught me, he used to say, first the nose and then the malt. Yeah, well, then you add your parsley and your onions, the mushrooms, and you pour on a good stock, and you put on your set, and you boil it for 1 hour. Right there. All right. Pop it in, Mrs. C.
Right. First, the nose.
Oh, my, it smells good. Oh, was there ever a Mr. Trotter? Or is the Mrs. a sort of honorary title the cooks have?
Oh, no, there was a Mr. Trotter, all right. Yeah, we had to chuck him out. Give me a moment. Yeah. We had a problem I could run in this place. Poor old Gussie. Bit of a dud, really. Died a drink. Been 13, somewhere by the sea.
Great yardwood.
Stop here, Wiggin. Go and get the suite.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, Augustus Trotter was a butler. My family threatened to shoot me if I didn't marry him. So I did. I bought this place for him, really. Give him something to do.
How did you ever get the money?
Hard work. Giving people what they wanted.
There was a rumour I heard that...
Ain't you been told that if you listen to rumours, you get your ears burnt off?
Gabbed it away like 2 o'clock. I tell you, this no good will come of it.
You and me going to be put in a book?
How about that, then, friend?
The data?
Is there a Mr. Merriman staying in the settle?
No, sir, not what I know him.
Mr. Arthur Cornelius Merriman.
Possibly there's an employee of that name in the establishment. If you'll excuse me for one moment. Bloke over there after you, Mr. Merriman.
Hey, what's he want?
I don't know. Not in trouble, are you?
No, what's trouble if you look for it?
Get rid of him, shall I?
Yeah.
I've ascertained that there has been a man by the name you mentioned employed in this hotel, but unfortunately, quite recently, his services have had to be dispensed with them.
Oh, that's a big pity. You know where I can find him, because I've got some really good news for him.
Oh.
Mr. Merriman, hold it! Everything's all right, Mr. Merriman.
Yeah, you mean all right? I don't like
it. He's got good news.
Arthur right. Cornelius Merriman are from Tidbits. You've won our trucks competition, and here is a cheque for £500.
Get it,
Mr. Merriman.
Get it, Mr. Merriman.
Get it, Mr. Merriman. Get it, Mr. Merriman. Get it, Mr. Merriman.
Get it, Mr. Merriman. Get it, Mr. Merriman. Get it, Mr. Merriman. Get it, Mr. Merriman. Get it, Mr. Merriman. Get it, Mr. Merriman. Get it, Mr. Merriman. Get it, Mr. Merriman. Get it, Mr. Merriman. Get it, Mr. Merriman. Get it, Mr. Merriman. Get it, Mr. Merriman. Get it, Mr. Merriman. Get it, Mr. Merriman. Get it, Mr. Merriman. Get it, Mr. Merriman. Get it, Mr. Merriman. Get it, Mr. Merriman. Get it, Mr. Merriman. Get it, Mr. Merriman. Get it, Mr. Merriman. Get it, Mr. Merriman. Get it, Mr.
Mr. Merriman, who refused to give his age.
He doesn't know it.
And admitted he had never ridden on a machine before. Told our reporter that he was off to see a bit of life before he roared off into the thick of London's West End traffic with a fortune in his pocket.
Well, I never. Like giving a baby a bum to play with.
He'll be back when he comes down to earth.
I don't know so much. I don't know if Mrs. Trotter will have him back. She's asked me to get hold of that temporary we had last year.
Well, I hope she don't give him the keys of the cellar this time.
Mm. I wish I could win a competition.
Perhaps Mr. Merriman will give you a ride on his billion. I say, Julian, I've had a marvellous idea. We'll thrill them all to the marrow. We'll take our pogo sticks, and then when we get bored, we can hop out of the window.
Well, let's practice. It'd be too shaming if we fell off.
I say, Julian, I'm Kanga.
And I'm Ruth.
What's the secret of making a success of a hotel like this?
There ain't any other hotel like this.
Oh, of course not.
Hot water, good food, and clean linen. We'll make a bed start.
It's all so beautiful. It's not like a hotel at all. I mean, all these beautiful things everywhere.
Yeah, well, I've got all this stuff because when I was young, I used to go around cooking at big country houses, isn't it? And I thought I'd make this place like one of them, sort of home from home for me guests. Oh, yeah. They'd be comfortable, be private, and no questions asked. And that don't mean I've tartan here, because I don't. I remember where I got this old chair at an auction. £4.05 that cost me. Yeah, a long time ago that was.
How old are you, Mrs. Trotter?
Well, you've got a cheek you have. Look, get me figures so I can keep my angel secret. You see that woman over there talking to the Major? Looks like a tart, but she ain't. Wrote a book about her, round the world in 80 beds. She's a Danish countess, been big game shooting in Mexico somewhere. They do say she's got roses tattooed on her breasts. I wouldn't bet on it. A young man talking to her, honourable thingamajig. He's a nice lad. Knew him before he was born. Spits when he speaks like a siphon. No wonder the way he's dead drunk. And the old countess's grandmother, she think nothing of going to Buckingham Palace wearing her false teeth as a brooch. His uncle, cut your corns for 5 shillings, your throat for 5 pounds. Don't talk to me about that family. I called her 5 loafers and her 2 small fishes. Hello, here we are. Is he a Saffron Warden? He's not a bit of good. Got India rubber ticks.
Oh, dearest Louisa, so flattering as always.
Now, there's his friend. Oh. And this is my Lossie. I'm sure you know about her.
Oh, I'm sure she does, knowing how discreet the guests are in this hotel.
It must be exhausting trying to immortalise my mother.
It is.
I'm told I'm the only mistake she ever made.
It was a very pretty one. I had a divine father.
Well, we must be off. Mrs. Colligan is giving a party, and she begged me to be early. She can't wait to meet Keith.
And I can't wait to get rid of both of you.
Oh, dear lady.
Really, Louisa, I can't think why you allowed Driftlow pansies like Walden in your hotel. They lower the tone dreadfully.
I'd like to know where I'd be if it weren't for people like him to pay the bills for scrim-shanking buggers like you. I don't know why you go around with this Nigel, Lossie, don't really.
He doesn't paw me like all your lecherous old sugar daddies. And he matches my new dress, don't you think?
I say, Louisa, do you think you could cash me a check?
I don't know. How much?
Could you manage a pony?
Oh, blimey. I think the only reason people come to this hotel anymore is to bounce dud checks and pee. And if you put that in your book, I'll have you up in court, miss.
Evening.
Oh, evening, sir.
Waiter. Bottle of the pomelo nine and some smoked salmon sandwiches.
Yes, sir.
Well, get moving, man.
Nice weather for the time of the year, sir.
Hadn't noticed.
Well, how's the machine?
The invention of the devil.
Oh, what an act. You drink that stuff. Gut rot.
Oh, I think it's yummy.
What do I call it?
A sidecar. Have some more.
Oh, no. Rather drink myths. Stick to champagne, that's what I say. Can't go wrong.
Martha, darling, champagne is just the teensiest, weensiest bit, vieux chapeau.
I'll give you vieux chapeau. Good thing Merriman's pushed off. Go balmy, trying to mix up this poison.
We just have rather different tastes, that's all.
Yeah, not only in drink.
Are you being horrid to me?
No, love. Where the menu go around with that tin pot little guardie?
Osbert, he's quite a pet.
Yeah, looks as if he ought to be kept in a kennel. He's a poop, so wet you can shoot snipe off of him.
He has marvellous connections. I thought you were horrid, poor Nigel.
He's a lounge lizard, that's all he is.
He's a lovely parcel carrier and terribly clever at getting tables and that sort of thing.
He ain't got a bean, you know that.
Of course, when I want beans, I go elsewhere.
Like poor old Steady Eddie. He comes moaning to me, my daughter's a hard little bitch and she's breaking his heart.
You're getting soft in your old age, Mummy. You know as well as I do that Eddie's a dirty old poncer. And he's got a wife and 4 children in Hampshire. It's quite grisly, really. Poor old thing.
Why do you go out with him, then?
Purely out of kindness. Anyway, there's safety in numbers.
How many more are there?
Ooh, tons. Dream dancers like the Raja. He thrills me to the marrow.
Oh, yeah, want to be careful with him. I've only last doing 3 ladies all at the same time, each on a different floor of the Ritz.
Mother, darling, I sing for my supper, but I won't go to bed for it. Oh, and there's, Noel and Valentine and Willie and whole cohorts of them. And David, of course, who always asks me to dance every Thursday at the embassy. I think he's the most sweet and charming man I've ever met.
Yeah, it takes after his granddad.
He asked me to go to the theatre last week. I'm hardly likely to be on the list of eligibles. His mother wouldn't exactly approve.
There
Fancy that.
What is it? Return of the prodigal.
I trust you've been satisfied, sir.
No, madam, but not entirely. The waiter doesn't know how to pour champagne. He's got garlic on his breath and dirty fingernails. And one of the sandwiches had a crush left on.
Oh, well, we're just going to have to pull up our socks then, aren't we? I can assure you he's a good deal cleaner than the last one we had. Your bill, sir.
4 quid, four?
Yeah, well, prices have gone up a bit lately.
Taylor robbery. Keep the change.
Hey, come on, my old friend. A little bit of a lie down with you, I think.
Hello, Lisa. Ready, darling?
Good night. I hope I haven't shocked you.
No, not exactly.
One day I hope I fall in love. Properly in love, like you and my father. But not just yet. It would be terribly cramping. Good night.
Good night. Enjoy yourselves. At my expense.
I'm all right. Mr. Merriman?
Well, I wouldn't call it that exactly. Get some black coffee and plenty of it.
Oh, yes. Did you see life, Mr. Merriman?
Yeah, I saw life all right. It wasn't much right home back.
You know, Mrs. Strutter, I think I've just about come to the last chapter.
Oh, yeah, what's that about? Funerals? I'm not dead yet, you know.
No, it's about men and love.
Oh, blimey. The older I get, the less I think I know about either. Men and love, eh?
Yeah.
I'll tell you one thing about Englishmen. They take more trouble over choosing a horse than they do a wife, and then they come to me complaining that they're misunderstood. Yeah, they're all the same. Men. Oh, it's in their nature, isn't it, to chase us? And it's our lookout if we get caught by a wrong'un. Mind you, most of us slip up sometime in our lives. I did. It's the drink. Of course, there are some men who can love only one woman, but there are very few. No more than most men to amuse themselves making love to a woman than it is to play poker or go racing. They're all luxuries, and most of them overused.
But Englishmen are meant to be more faithful than others.
Faithful? Well, it depends what you call faithful. I mean, these men are coming here, very famous names, some of them, going to bed with a different girl every night. They'd be onto their lawyers if you was to suggest that they wasn't faithful to their wives. Of course, most of them got pots of money, which helps. It's not everything. You can buy caviar and champagne and good food and women's bodies, but you can't buy their hearts. Sex is only the carrot to get the donkey into the stable. After that, it's a lottery. Now, I used to say, if you find love, frame it so you can look back on it. And that's what I did. Here he is. My Charlie. I shan't never love anyone else. But the measles love is with me. Only get it once. Oh, I'm all right. I'm very happy. He means more to me now than he did when he was alive. Almost. And I've got my Lossie now.
What about God?
Who? God? Blimey, you don't half hop about a bit.
I notice you often invoke his name.
Oh, yeah, well, that don't mean nothing. It's just my way of speaking. He wouldn't mind.
Oh, so you believe in him?
Oh, yeah, of course I do. Just don't bother him like some do. I mean, got to get on with life, haven't you? Mind you, sometimes if things get a bit, dismal Desmond, I'll hop across to the church in Piccadilly, have a bit of a chat. Cheers me up, no end.
What about life after death?
Oh, I don't know. But nobody does, do they? Not for sure. No, my guess is as good as the Archbishop of Canterbury's or the Pope's. So let's look on the bright side, hope for the best. That's what I say.
Oh, I didn't mean to interrupt.
No, you're not coming. Sit in.
I can't. I'm on duty. I said I'd look after Fred at the hall whilst I took Mary at the exhibition at Wembley.
Oh, well, leave the door open. We'll have a glass of wine. If that old cripple's still alive, I'll be talking to him up. He mounts like the bottom of a canary cage.
Major.
Ma'am.
You've known Mrs. Trotter a very long time.
Oh, yes, indeed. A very long time. Now, let me see.
Oh, don't go into that. Okay. That is not graves.
What do you think is the secret of Mrs. Trotter's success?
What do you mean, in life?
Yeah.
Well, I don't want to give her a sermon here, do we?
Why not?
Well, I'd say it was humanity.
Yeah.
That's it. Understanding people, making them comfortable and happy. No, giving, not taking.
Oh, he's a terrible old butter-upper when it comes to women.
I believe him.
Yeah, well, maybe. What you've given, you still have. And what you've saved, you lost. That's what they say. Oh, there you are. Bottle of wine. Pommery 09, if there's any left. Use your motorbike. I'll hurry you up.
Merriman, may I ask you a question?
Yes?
What do you think is the secret of Mrs. Trotter's success?
Go on. You can say what you like.
Success this place. Well, Miss, I put it down to have been a snob and a bully. Both very useful running your tale of this sort. Oh, yes, very important.
Oh, it's lovely. It really is. Were there any real lions there?
Oh, yes. And bears. And silver foxes. And a real waterfall in the Canadian Pavilion.
Then we went down the coal mine. Oh. Made Mary feel quite at home. Pit ponies, Davy lamps, everything.
What have you got, Ethel?
He's your swanny whistle. Oh, I made about them. They're the lightest thing.
Oh, no, we're not going to have that all day, are we?
And Joseph and I, That is, Mr. Starr and I stroked the black and white china cat in the Palace of Industry. Oh, and there was a big statue of the Prince of Wales made of butter.
There's someone strangling that girl.
Why can't you listen to Mary and Mr. Starr telling us about their exhibition at Wembley instead of listening to that thing?
Wembley? Not an exhibition at all compared to the great exhibition, Crystal Palace and Hyde Park.
I like the look of Gay Sultana.
How many times have Starr and I told you not to waste your money on two-year-olds selling platers? Oh. Now, Fairfield swearing at 2:30, that's more like it.
We might pop along to Sandown, right?
Oh, I can't go racing with you every day.
Oh, sorry, I don't get much chance now.
Enjoyed your stay up here, have you?
Oh, very much. It's been marvellous seeing all my old friends again.
Still, nice to get back to the peace and quiet of the country after the hurly-burly London town, eh?
Yes, it's very nice, well, very peaceful, as you say.
What do you do all day? Fish?
Well, the fishing proved a bit of a disappointment, actually, but there are plenty of other things to do. I've taken up golf. Not much of a game. And I do a bit of gardening, you know, and we generally manage a game of bridge in the evenings. And things will be livening up no end soon. Olive's starting up a pottery in the village. She wants me to help with it. Oh, it's, I'm very happy, really.
Pottery, eh? Mm. You're bald stiff, aren't you, Major? Too good manner to say so, but you are, aren't you? I can read you like a book. Always good.
It's not Olive's fault, not a bit. She looks after me awfully well. It's just... Well, I suppose I was too old to transplant, you know. I don't seem able to get any roots down. And coming back here has been like coming home. Living here all these years, taking it all rather for granted, it's become my home.
Yeah.
And without really knowing it, you'll probably laugh, but I've discovered I've grown very fond of you. Very fond indeed. If you know what I mean.
Yeah, I know what you mean. Now, why should I laugh at a compliment? You've seen me through some difficult times, Major. Took some doing. Don't worry. You don't have to spend all your time down in Suffolk. Come up here whenever you like. I'll keep your own room on for you. You come up for meetings, regimental reunions. Olive won't mind. She'll be too busy with her pottery to notice. We'll do a bit of racing. That way you can have your champagne and drink it.
I knew you'd have the answer. I wouldn't have risked embarrassing you by my confession.
Well, I'm glad you did.
Excuse me, madam. Could me and Mr. Starr have a word with you, please?
Yeah, come in. Now, you stay, Major. Oh, what's this delegation here? What's the trouble?
Well, it's not exactly any trouble, madam. You see...
Well, you see, madam, me and Mr. Starr... Joseph, I should say.
Oh, should you?
Well, we've been thinking... of getting married.
Married? No, you take my advice.
No, excuse me, madam. I think I should explain that we're...
We're engaged.
Officially.
Well, you'd be quiet about it, must I?
Oh, we thought we'd wait to tell you till it was...
Official.
What does that mean? Put in the tones or tell the king or something?
The ring. We just didn't want to make things difficult for you.
Not make things difficult. Well, you are making things difficult for me, aren't you? You both know my room as well as I do. No married servants.
Yes, madam.
Well, how did it happen? You're both swamped by a sudden passion or something?
Oh, no, madam. Mr. Starr's been fussing about for years and years.
Oh, has he?
Only I never would take him serious. And then, last week, when we were at the Wembley exhibition, well, first, we both of us got the chance to stroke the lucky gat in the gas pavilion. And then Joseph caught me unawares, as you might say, on the Jack and Jill slide, and I said I would. He isn't much to look at, but he's got nice little ways, and then I'm very fond of Fred. They need a home.
Well, I was under the obviously mistaken impression that they had a home. I hope they'll find another one.
If that means, madam, that you wish to dispense with our services, my fiancé and I...
Oh, shut up, Starr! You haven't given me time to speak, let alone think. I'll let you know my decision at a later date. When it happens. If it happens. Sneaking up behind my back, getting themselves in danger. Disloyal, underhand.
My dear Louisa, that's going a bit far. You could hardly expect Starr to consult...
I'm not talking about Starr. He most likely consulted Sporting Life or his bloody dog. I'm talking about Mary. My Welsh Mary. Well, my mother, father, sister to all these years, dragged her out of the gutter, giving her everything.
She's given you...
Nothing. Not a dicky bird, not so much as a buy or leave. Blackmail, that's what it is, coming in here, chatting out she's engaged, flashing a bloody ring in my face. And I bet I was the last to be told. I bet the whole hotel knew. The kitchen, old Mary Mabel, Mrs. C, all conspirators, and you.
What?
You knew about it, didn't you?
Well, yes, I did, actually. They told me. I gave them a drink last night, actually.
Et tu, Major. Are they really as frightened of me as all that?
Well, no, not frightened,
I'm exactly. Soft in my old age. They're going to rot me. Well, I'll show them. If they get married, I'm going to sack those two. I'm going to be made a fool of by my own staff. They can go to hell, as far as I'm concerned.
Humanity, understand?
Yeah, well, those weren't my words. Don't chuck them back in my face now.
There's that little flat empty at the top of the attic.
What do you know about that all of a sudden?
Things won't be any different. It'd probably save you money.
No, they won't. Never so good when they married old servants. Wouldn't have happened before the war.
It's not before the war. Things have changed. Never look back. Seem to remember that was one of Mrs. Trotter's favourite sayings.
Well, it was a bloody silly one if it was. Well, I needed a drink. And there's another of them.
Another what?
Another of her favourite sayings.
When I heard the news, you could have knocked me down with a feather. I said to Ethel, I said, well, she'll knock the stuffing out of those two, you mark my words.
No, well, love will sway, love will have its way. That's what they say, Mrs. Cotter.
You're becoming quite a poet, Mr. Merritt.
Mrs. Trotter's ringing for wine, so come up quick.
Sir, she would have thought she needed something which stronger than wine.
Ethel, what's the matter with you? Let me say, use your handkerchief. We don't want salt in the sorbet.
Them two came married.
Well, what's wrong with that? We've both been married, haven't we?
We're both widows.
Now, look, I'm not speaking for myself, but widows can get married again, especially young, good-looking ones like you.
I don't want to get married again, Mrs. Cochran. All I want is my Clive back. That's all I want.
Time will heal.
No, it won't. And I'll never get to see that Wembley exhibition. Not unless they have outings for all widows.
Look, you go and sit down. I'll finish this. She does make life hard for herself, that girl.
Don't sound like Dame Patty to me. Meant to be Hopera, Kozai Van Tunai.
More like a parrot house at the zoo. It's an hour of Irish song and humour.
Hey.
Bloke who invented that thing should be shot. That's what I think, and Fred agrees with me. Here, Mary, what about this? Where is it?
What is it? My hands are wet.
Colston. Corner shop in agreeable suburban district. Tobacconist, confectionery, news agency. Established business. That's a nice area. A lot of good places to take Fred walks.
I'm not slaving away day and night in a crowded little shop. While you go down the pub for a chat, or take Fred on the recreation ground.
Recreation ground? There's parks in Colston. Big
where park. There was recreation grounds where I come from. We stay in here.
Slaving the rest of our lives for her?
It's not slaving, for one thing. And another thing, she's been kind enough to offer us a nice little flat to ourselves.
Only because she wants to keep us.
And another thing, there's such a thing as loyalty.
Loyalty? After the way she spoke to us the other day?
She had a bit of a shock, that's all. And no wonder.
Look, Mary, when we're married...
Well, we aren't married yet, are we? And I sometimes wonder if we ever will be.
You serious?
No. But Fred and I are staying here, aren't we, Fred? Whatever you decide to do.
All the women turning against me, as per usual. No wonder men never get a chance.
Never have and never will.
If I were to search my memory for the finest earthly example of a guardian angel, I should unhesitatingly plump for Mary Phillips, who looks after Mrs. Trotter with devoted tenderness and attention. I like that.
Fussy old hen, more like.
I like the whole thing, actually. It's quite remarkable.
Finished then, have you, Major?
Hmm. I was flattered to see that one of the suggestions that I'd made were included. Who else had read it?
Well, I haven't, and I'm not going to. Here he is.
I like the beginning. Hmm? My cousin had warned me that the rates were negligible if Mrs. Trotter liked you. Exorbitant if she didn't. That the food was delicious when you finally got it. That most of the guests were mad as hatters. And that Mrs. Trotter was the most remarkable woman in England.
Absolutely true. Should be a remarkable thing, you know.
Yeah, it should be. But it's not going to be, because it's going in there, where it belongs.
Can't do that.
I can, I have.
But it's all true.
Yeah, no, but it's private. It's not going to be written down so that people have no business who can read it.
The poor American woman.
She's not poor, her cousin Ricky's got $40 million. You know, I told her I don't like scribblers and all their scribbles. That's my life she's run about. I'll do what I like with my life. Always have done, always will. Oh, come on. Says that we'll miss the party.
You're weaving love into a mad jazz pattern, ruled by pantaloon. Poor little rich girl, don't drop a stitch too soon.
At the club one evening, Jones was telling all his pals how much he hated girls, despised their golden curls. You'll never catch me with a girl, you bet your life, said he. Girls possess no charms for me. Then one chap at Jones began to leer, picked up his cane and said to him, come here. Hold your hand out, you naughty boy. Hold your hand out, you naughty boy. Last night in the pale moonlight, I saw ya with a nice girl in the pub. You were strolling full of joy. And you told me you'd never kissed a girl before. Hold your hand out, you naughty boy. Come on, everyone.
Hold your hand out, you naughty boy. Hold your hand out, you naughty boy.
me.
Forbid. Good night, everyone.
Good night.
And God bless you.